Right.
More meds. All right. Should be live soon.
Okay, cool. I'll keep an eye on it. Oh, yep. There we go. It's coming up.
Turn you up a wee bit more, but I think you're all right.
All right, cool. Once this bloody advert is finished.
Yeah, you block ours and still hasn't caught up with Twitch yet.
Ah, God.
Oh, it's the Breath of the Wild clone.
Oh, that one, yeah. Oh, God, something Impact, whatever it's called.
Yeah, Genshin Impact, yeah. Right. I haven't played it, but it's absolutely just Breath of the Wild. Like, they can be like, no, it's more than that. It's incredibly blatant.
Well, apparently it is quite different, actually, to play. It's just its art style is literally Breath of the Wild.
I mean, I've seen the explosions. They're just Breath of the Wild explosions.
Yeah, essentially.
Which is fine. All right, so I did stream on Thursday. I did a bunch of quests. Everyone is high level. Which is good. I didn't quite finish all of the quests. I did get the Balfagar's Tomb stuff done. And I did Ryan and Ricky's 5th skill branch quest, so they have their skill branch, which is nice.
Wow.
I also I got up to like level 92, 93 on stream, and off stream I bopped around killing all the unique monsters I could find.
Mm-hmm.
So now everyone's like level 94, I think maybe someone's level 95.
Nice.
I did... Oh my god, I haven't fought a lot of these unique monsters before, because all of them are completely optional. Like, you don't have to beat any of these. So there's this dinosaur in Machna Forest, who's level 99.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a fucker, he has topple spikes.
Ah, right.
Every time you hit him, he topples you.
Oh.
So I had Shulk, Fiora, and Sharla, and every time like Shulk hit it, we were toppled. And I would purge it, and the purge hit would topple me.
Okay, so you couldn't charge your talent gauge in time.
Yes, so I couldn't charge it in time, so I would get it up, and he would have his aura back, I would purge, and I would be toppled again, and waiting for like Sharla to pick me up, because Fiora was just constantly toppled.
Yeah.
Because she attacks so fast, like, in between, like, her getting up and me, like, purging, she would hit it and topple again. So poor Sharla was trying to do double time, but I did beat it. Yeah, Ricky's level 95. Yeah, there we go. So,
hey.
I did beat the dinosaur. It got hairy at times, but I did beat him. And I have some outfits in everyone, so... We have very... I love the dinosaur arms on Fiora.
Yeah, it was pretty sweet.
Very, very good. I have Melia in her Valkyrie outfit in pink this time, which is nice.
Ooh, yeah, that's pretty good.
I'm keeping Sharla in this outfit because I really like this outfit I've got for Sharla. And I've decided that along with Ricky, who is in dad mode with that fish, for Thursday. That the guys are just gonna be in like, yeah, casual mode.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, some pants, some shoes.
You don't want to overdress to go and defeat God. That's just
absolutely. Look, we've got Dad. This is Dad Squad here.
Yeah.
This is Dad. Yeah, casual God killing, and yeah. Ryan's in looking very casual. I like that the navy of that like matches up with the prodigal trousers pretty nicely.
Yeah, it actually does fit pretty well.
Pretty good. He's also got gold glasses to go with his gold chain.
You gotta accessorize, because
yeah,
I mean...
Absolutely. So yeah, if we look at the quest list, it's much narrower now. I have got this lily, I have to go give it back to Dylan, that was in the tomb.
Mm-hmm.
I still have a couple of things to get for the Replica Monado. I have to go kill the Dragon King, but I can kill that dragon now. I am level 94. I can go kill that dragon.
Will the fight take less than 5 hours this time?
Hopefully. And we actually have all three giants' treasures, so we can go and have a look at this door.
I'm always up for looking at doors.
The thing I'm going to start with is I have 10 heart-to-hearts.
Oh.
I didn't do any heart-to-hearts on Thursday. I just wanted to try and get, like, these quests done.
Right.
So we have a bunch. We have a lot of... Basically, I have no blue affinity anymore. Everyone is purple cloud. Ooh. And Shulk is pink heart with everyone.
Ah, Shulk.
Shulk just coming in.
Exiled from the party.
Absolutely. As much as I can, anyway. Thankfully, no more Telethia, I would hope. So, yeah, we have... 3 heart-to-hearts we can see in Colony 9. So there's one up here, one there, one here, and one on the shore. And I'm pretty sure this one here is the one I can't get yet. So I'm going to have to go all the way over to that shore.
Well, that's convenient.
Let me go with the ones that have landmarks next to them.
Yeah, that probably makes sense.
Right, so we have Sharla and Ricky. Oh, yeah, Ricky won.
Yes.
Starting off strong.
He is in the best outfit for a heart-to-heart right now.
He really is. I also lost my shit when I realized he has a fish for a weapon. When I saw that before Thursday stream, I was like, oh my god, he has a fish!
I'm surprised he's, like, willing to hit things with it rather than eat it.
It's true. Maybe it's, like, too hard to eat, and that's why he uses it as a weapon.
Yeah, maybe.
Heart-to-heart guide up. Tell Ricky about Mekon. Why does Ricky wants to bash Mekon in? Ah, it's true. He is no one.
We're not really fighting them anymore.
It's fine. Don't worry about it.
Well, he wants to learn some history.
Yeah, he wants to be smart. So, this is the right answer, but it feels mean.
Ricky, you're thick. Why do you want to know this?
Yeah, why are you curious, Ricky? You just want to know about food, normally. I mean, he's wearing glasses now. He's trying very hard, you know?
He's very professorial right now, yeah.
He is absolutely professor at a conference outfit right
now.
That is
he's in Hawaii at the conference, having a good time, and then sleeping through the lectures. He's definitely geared for the nighttime activities.
Sitting village, pawning.
I suppose that's not too different from how academics spend time at conferences, the way the Nopon live in Frontier Village.
Yeah, it's very true. You can really tell who are like students and who are professors and tenured professors as well.
Yes.
At conferences, because the level of formality drops off a cliff.
Someone in
socks and sandals, that's a 30-year professor right there.
Yeah, it disappears as job security increases.
Yeah. I was fighting Mekon since I was knee-high to a grasshopper.
Oh, Ricky.
Oh, no, you were definitely good enough, Ricky. See, no, Ricky, that's not true.
That's nonsense, or it's not true.
Same thing, but one is the right answer.
Yes.
Normally, you're very confident, Ricky. Yeah. You bash those Mekon in. It is true, there's not a lot of Mekon stuff in, like, the Nopon village. There are no Mekons in Mac the Forest at all.
No. Is there any reason for that, or is it just, like, they don't care about
I feel like
Nopon.
They just don't care about the Nopon.
You'd think so, because, I mean, surely they come from the Bionis as well, and therefore...
Yes, they absolutely
do. You could return them.
I don't know. It does feel like maybe even the Mekon are like, Nopon are too cute to kill.
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe they're like, well, we've got bigger fish to fry first. And
yeah, the humans in the high end here definitely have the weaponry to fight back.
Yeah. I suppose with the Nopon as well, you can't really make a face out of a Nopon, can you? Although that
would if you ever tried.
That would be the best face.
It would be the best face Mekon ever, yes. 100%. I'm surprised he never tried it.
Now, Echo's maybe a bit,
I think it's also more difficult for them to get, like, up to Mac the Forest. It's not very exposed.
Yeah, I suppose you'd... because you have to... It's under RFC is the thing, isn't it? So you'd have to fly, like, around the back of the Bionis.
Yeah.
You're much easier striking Alchemoth for the colony.
And, like, we got to it through the marsh, which was traveling through the Bionis as well.
Yeah, exactly. So. And then from that, you teleport up to the sea, which is above it, so...
Yeah, it would just be... probably just quite difficult to get to, and they probably they've got the Homs to kill first.
Yeah. So this is a high Entia ship then?
Yes. It had the high Entia defense thing in it. I think Melia's about to explain. Hello.
Yeah. Oh well, I apologize for spoiling it. Well, there we go.
Alchemar training ship. It did
Mystery
have ether cylinders in it. Yeah, this is a high Entia ship. We did fight the machine. Yeah, that was, they were like, that's not Mechon. It's like, yeah, because it was high Entia.
Yeah, it's so odd as well, because it comes right before such a big thing, obviously, with the attack on the colony. Mm-hmm. And then it's just dropped until this part, because it's not actually that important.
Yeah, it's not irrelevant. It just kind of sets up that there's technology other than Mechon.
Yeah, it's a bit strange, though. In terms of kind of like prioritization of things, it feels a bit weird. I guess the kind of comparison would be Skies of Arcadia.
Yeah.
Where one of the first things you do that game is you go to, I can't even remember the name of it, but there's this tiny little island where you go and loot for equipment.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the very end of the game, like, and you go there and that like precedes you because you miss the attack on your home island where people get kidnapped and your dad gets taken away.
Yep.
And then at the end of the game, that little island you went to is like the entrance to the big like silver continent.
Yep.
So that's all set up and payoff for that. And this kind of feels like it should be similar. Like, it should be that kind of level of setup, really.
I feel
really.
Like it is just, like, a background element. Like, I'll look out over the town, and you can see that Colony 9 was built on a crashed Alchemoth ship. Like...
Right.
That's where Colony 9, like, is just built on. And it never really comes up without saying, like, this is the first time the game's, like, actually addressed this.
Yeah.
Hey, this is the bit of the ether cylinders, and oh, yeah... This is a crashed Alchemoth trading ship.
Right, but it's weird to kind of draw attention to that for the moment and then kind of completely ignore it for the rest of the game.
Yeah.
Like, if it's a background element, you'd think it'd be like this, where it's just like, this is the only time it comes up, rather than being right before the inciting incident.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's not a big deal. It's just kind of like, oh, that's a little weird. Maybe there was something that was meant to be more of this in the initial draft.
Yeah, it could be as well. There was supposed to be more of an element with the high Entia and the Homs.
Yeah.
And they just sort of kept it in because it's fucking cool as shit.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't take away from stuff. It's just maybe a little untidy.
Because, yeah, this is, like, part of the ship here. And, if we have a look down at the town, there's the anti-guns, and you can really see that, yeah, like, Colony 9 was built on top of this crashed Alchemoth ship. Because you can see from the, like, architecture of it, it looks like the underside of Alchemoth.
Mm-hmm. And it looks nothing like anything on the colony.
No.
Like, Homs technology.
Yeah. And it's, I like it as just like a subtle background element.
Mm-hmm.
It's something cool. It builds up the world quite a bit. We're in this valley where the ship, like, crash landed and clearly couldn't get back out, so it just stayed here.
Yeah. And again, it's one of these things that people are just kind of used to and no one really calls attention. It's like, why does this place look so weird? Like, none of our technology looks like this.
Like, we just, this is just where we live. We kind of have to live where we can, or the Mechon will kill us all.
Yeah, it's all just right. Like, maybe a while ago people discussed that, but at this point it's like, yeah, it's fine, that discussion's over.
It's where we live. Like, you don't really think about the mechanics of where you live, like...
Mm, it's true.
Honestly, you think about, like, Edinburgh, which is built on top of is it a dead volcano, rather than just an active?
Yeah, it's an extinct volcano.
Extinct volcano. And you're like, why should they build an extinct volcano?
Look, we got to build a castle somewhere. It's
right?
A pretty hilly place. when we built it, we weren't exactly up on volcanic studies, okay?
Mm-hmm. You're just like, that's a big hill. Let's just build it there. Why not?
Plunk it on top of that one. Yeah, nice defensible position.
And yeah, this had like big-ass guns that could hit the Mechon. So I was just like, fuck it, we'll just live here. And then... they just lived here forever, and it's like, well, where do these guns come from? It's like,
well, there's a good supply of ether over there. It's like, do we know where that is? Like, it's just ether, let's just use it.
Cape, right, chores over there. Nothing here is scary anymore, which is, again, like, hilarious when I was, like, terrified of these goddamn piranhas at one point.
I imagine at this point there's about 5 enemies in the game that are still scary.
If that, yeah. I mean, but how many super bosses are there?
Oh god, what, there's... I think there is about five or six of them, yeah.
I think it is. I did see the bunny.
Oh, okay.
The 108 bunny.
Yep.
Why not? Yeah, so there are, like, yeah, only a handful. Now that I'm level 94, 95, even level 99 enemies aren't scary. Even that fucking dinosaur in the forest with topple spikes, what a jerk. Even he's not scary, he's just annoying.
I mean, he's a dead jerk now.
He's dead. He is dead. I did kill him. I also killed, there's a level 98 pterodactyl nice. In Mark the Forest that I killed. It was much easier because he did not have spikes.
Yeah, that would definitely help.
Yeah, I popped around. There were a few, like, 90s unique monsters around. More than I expected, honestly.
Yeah, the game does have a lot of content for kind of high level stuff, which... Yeah. It's not that unusual, but I still guess it's quite surprising that it keeps that nice progression. Normally you kind of go, oh look, here's like your end game, and then suddenly, oh, I get another 20 levels so you can fight the super bosses.
Yeah, there are two types of JRPGs when it comes to that. There's ones that like basically have nothing after the end level. You get to like level 40, that's your end level, and then you're done. And there's games that are like, hey, we have all this post-game content, but it's like 50 levels above you. Good luck, motherfucker.
Get to grinding, asshole.
Yeah, like, FF5 is very like that. Not so much levels, yeah. But in, like, job levels.
Yeah, I suppose you get things like the movers that help with that, but, yeah.
Go back, you could help out. She's like, I'm missing Colony 6.
Yeah.
And Shara's like, yeah, but I also had to go attack and dethrone God, so...
We have been at Colony. We've been at Colony 6 a lot, though.
Mm-hmm,
like,
mm-hmm.
She can just teleport there whenever she wants.
Yeah, exactly.
You know how many fucking rainbow slugs we collected for that asshole?
Many. I have three more still.
Exactly. Just like, how many slugs do you want, Juju?
He only wanted two, actually.
I know. All this trouble we went to get them.
Which was barely any, honestly. Which is kind of funny.
That's true. In this case. They're quite cute together.
They are cute. Yeah, I would have. What?
Friends just agree with each other all the time.
Oh, there's the Lord Lids. Be angry as a friend. Charlotte knows what's up.
Yeah.
Oh, Charlotte's teasing him. It's very hard to stay sad around Ryan. He is just, like, lovably dumb.
Yeah, he's just such a nice guy.
Alright, so I think that's all the ones I can get in Colony 9.
Mm-hmm.
Before we leave Colony 9, there's some other stuff I want to do. So there's, there's an achievement for forging, like, an absolute shit ton of affinity links with, like, all the people in the towns. And I have a list of people to talk to forge some links, so...
Look, I know the episode title here
go.
Says... I know it says attacking and dethroning God, what but we've it? Got much more important things to
Absolutely.
Do first.
Absolutely! I think she won't actually, like, give me this unless I talk to her, like, at midnight.
Right.
Again, the people who only give you, like, specific links if you, like, talk to them at certain times are so weird. I had this problem before, so I think if I change it to midnight, she will then forge a link. There we go!
Link has been forged.
Link is forged. Thankfully, I only have to talk to people in Colony 9 to get this achievement. But yeah, let's go around forging some Colony 9 links. It was magic. Thank you for the resub. Yeah, attack and dethrone social links. We have Sylvan here, who has a link with Dazza, the Nilfon merchant.
Oh.
There are a lot of weird links that you just don't get if you don't come back and talk to people every so often. Made a handsome reward. So yes, Sylvan is now rich. She's now stonking rich.
Still taking this asshole for all he's worth, though.
Yeah, absolutely. Wouldn't you?
Well, yeah. Definitely.
Alright, so I have to go to the military base now. There are three people in here for me to talk to.
Hello.
Talk to Arno. They're trustworthy souls. I am a celebrity do-gooder, though.
You don't act like it.
Hmm, maybe.
I could learn a thing about being considerate.
Can I talk to him again? Yes, he has a link with Shura. Shura hasn't had any links. She gets no links before she goes off to the tomb, and then you have to do all the tomb quests, and then when she comes back, she then gets links with people.
Right.
It's really weird. I think it's because she, like, pops off that they, like, didn't give her any. I talked to, Miffy. Hello? Huge fireworks. Yeah, so remember that quest I did 80 hours ago?
Yeah, I think part two of this.
Yeah, apparently I never talked to Miffy Miffy afterwards, so she gets a link to Sesame because of it. Then we're going to talk to Mr. Nice Guy TM here. Who has a link.
Oh, no.
Sorry. I would rather not, but he has a link.
God damn it.
Hello.
At least I thought he did. I wrote him down.
Stop whining about...
Fuck it, I'm not talking to him again. It's fine. Alright, now we're changing to day. Because that was all the nighttime people. Yeah, fuck it. He didn't give me a link even though he should have, so fuck him. Alright, let's talk to him.
You'll come crawling back if you need the achievement.
No!
You know it, I know it, we all know it.
Again, it's like, am I just at that the wrong time?
Yeah, maybe.
Like, definitely got, like, a link from this guy. Maybe I am, like, too late, too early. Who knows?
Hey.
Alright. Go on to the next one. I'll come back if, like, I don't get it. But I should get it. I actually talked to more people than I needed to get the achievement, so...
Oh, okay. So hopefully it'll work out.
Yep. Alright, so Raul, I think, is this dude over here.
Yep.
Raul.
Good day.
There we go. I think it's Miller, who is, like, not a lazy bum anymore, I guess.
Yeah, I guess so.
Alright, and now I have to talk to Francois. Anyway, she's given me a few links, but she's really weird about it. Right, talking about Nurine. Wow!
Whoa.
Wow, I didn't need to know that lady. That's none of my business.
It's not anyone's business.
Right? Mean as hell. Alright, now I have to talk to Cheryl, who is up there. She's the old lady we got the quest from, like, her son died and left a bunch of his items across the Bionis.
Yeah, ended up quite far away from here as well.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Oh, hello.
Oh, Bionis just...
Yep. Helper lad. And you can rely on. Alright, then there's Marcia. Here. Yeah, it sure was.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, that's what happens when your kids die.
It's true.
Really grateful. There we go. Oops. Roots across the world. That got me 30,000 experience, which is, you know, pretty good chunk of change. But that is the last achievement for creating affinity links amongst, like, residents.
So is that, like, a certain amount of links of, like, the entire
yes,
game?
Yes, yeah. Like, across, like, this whole affinity chart, like, all of this, you have to make a certain number of links between people. This isn't the absolute fullest one, but it's about as good as it gets.
Right, I mean, I guess there has to be some leeway because there's certain quests that can lock certain affinities. And obviously, like, Alchemoth, you can lose all of those.
Oh yeah, that's the thing. Alchemoth can actually stop you from getting that achievement. For sure. You do have to keep an eye on that. So yeah, I've got 49 out of 50 trials, so helped almost everyone. It doesn't say how many. Just almost everyone. So the only one I'm now missing is every heart to heart. Which is a lot of them. I just got that one, the 40 of them.
Yeah.
And I don't think I'm going to get this on stream, because that's a lot of affinity, but, I mean, I do have, like, Purple Cloud with everyone. Alright, one last, link, because this one's really funny.
Ryan gets no respect.
Telling Ryan to his face that he saw last week.
Talking about him in like the third person too. God, kids are so mean.
Kids are incredibly mean. Alright, back on the heart to heart trail, we have I'll probably also fight the dragon while he's here. Might as well.
Yeah.
And yeah, there's two heart to hearts in Call of Duty 6 I can do. I'm gonna figure out what I wanna fight the dragon with. Like it probably should be Shulk, as much as I would love to ditch him. This guy's talent art is awful. So I'm probably gonna go with the squad.
Yeah, he's got he's got the instant kill move, hasn't he?
Yeah, I can't really do anything about the instant kill move apart from just having specific stuff on. There's two things that can stop it. Debuff resist, which is all debuffs, which includes instant death, and there's also Divine Protect, which is instant death, 50%.
Right.
So, wow, I actually have, yeah, I got must have gotten these very recently, because I did not have these when I fought the dragon last time.
Yeah.
I put them on. That was basically my, strategy for beating it low level, was put a lot of debuff resist, night vision, and, just, that all that sort of stuff on. Mm-hmm. Try and stop myself from being insta-killed, and it worked pretty well, honestly. So yeah, let me put one on her. Oh, there's a debuff resist, 75%, which again, I must have just gotten that in some of my quest stuff, so. Because I did not have that level of debuff resist. Yeah. My heart to heart are one in the fountain, one down here. Are those the only two? Yeah, that must be the last two of Colony 6, so.
Yeah.
Pretty good. Let's go fight a dragon, though. Let's have a break from heart to hearts to fight a dragon.
The thing you want to do after having some nice conversations.
Yeah, absolutely. He's going to be a lot easier now that he's yellow. Because I'll actually be able to hit him.
Ryan gets this and he doesn't even get to let off steam by killing a dragon.
No, sorry. Look at me actually hitting this dragon. This is bullshit.
Bit disappointing it doesn't play UNOR name. Oh no, you. Yeah, the unique monster music for this guy.
Yeah, normally it does, but...
I guess he's not technically a unique monster, he's like a quest dude.
Yeah, they're a little, weird about that. Some of them do and some of them don't.
Actually, Lero's saying that he knows our names, obviously, so he doesn't need to learn them.
Yeah, that's fair. Alright, I don't think I can topple him. Was it Amy? I feel like he's immune. Let me give him a shot though.
Yeah, why not?
I don't think I ever hit him to topple him, so. Ooh, you can topple him.
There you go. Daze.
I can daze him. I can continue dazing him.
Yep.
Yeah, no, there's no lore reason. There's no reason for this. You just. To finish Colony 6, kill a dragon.
Yeah. Well, I mean, how else are you going to reconstruct a colony?
Sure. But yeah, you can see how much easier this is at level 94 than it was at level 8.
Yeah, we've already done more damage, probably in that one chain attack, than in a half hour we did.
The problem was that I could have killed him at level 84. He wasn't killing me. I was surprisingly able to just keep trucking, but I wasn't doing any damage to him, which is a huge problem when he has a buttload. Ooh, sword drones. When he has a buttload of health. Mm-hmm. I could have held on the sword drones, but no way of knowing if it was just gonna fizzled out or not before I got back.
You didn't get around to Charlotte again anyway, so.
Yeah. Yeah, level 94, and this is no problem.
Wow. Let's not count chicken. Something bad might happen.
That's just true. He might still, you know,
yeah,
go off. But yeah, if there had been a, like, reason to, Oh, I think I saw, is that Fiora and Charla now, pink?
Yes, it is.
But yeah, if there had been, like, a better reason to, like, fight him, like, I might have just off-stream, like, it.
Yeah.
But he doesn't really have anything behind him. So there's, like, no reason to do it. Like, if anything, I would have wanted to kill the level 97 spider as early as possible, but that level 97 spider is surrounded by level 93 and 96 sea spiders, and all sorts of shit that just make it really hard to fight her. Like, this guy is easy to, like, kind of practice on, because he's just all out here on his own.
Yeah.
But, like, the spider has, like, all that stuff. Like, Fiora's skill branch, I still have to get that quest, which I can get now.
Yeah.
There's so much more stuff stuck behind that. Mm-hmm. Then stuck behind this dragon.
Yeah, absolutely. This is just like, I mean, it is literally the final thing to do to finish off Kali 6.
Yep. And yeah, I haven't really died at all. I haven't had like any vision.
Yeah, it's just been chain attack after chain attack, really.
Yep. Yeah, I'm about to kill him with this chain attack. Oh, Fiora.
Not quite.
Oh, didn't top on that time. Shot getting the kill. Oh. Alright, here we go. I eliminated the threat of the formidable enemy. And he should, I hope, give me the Everflame I need for the Replica Manada quest. Sure did.
Yep. You did get Affinity Coin from defeating him, though, so I guess he does count as a unique monster.
He does count, yeah.
But doesn't play the music. Yeah.
I don't... Well, yeah, we're technically throwing the Demon King. Am I at 100% now, Juju? Yes, I am. I guess I don't get anything for that.
I guess not.
Satisfaction of having 100%, I guess.
And I mean, your Aether Planters are now working okay.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, Colony 6 is now, like, complete. It's good.
Yeah.
Alright, gonna go get that fourth Manada replica. The other one is the Slobos Rocks, which is the guys on top of the Valet Mountains.
Right.
I'll
almost
certainly go fight one of them today.
Yeah, Final Marcus.
I'm going up there for the quest, so. Yeah. And I'm gonna try and fight Final Marcus. I really need to be 95 before I do that, but. I've got a couple of quests to do, and I'm almost certainly going to get to level 95 before I go up there, so it's not a problem.
I mean, you got Ricky who's already at that level anyway,
yeah,
so.
Manada Dogma. Ho ho. Lower defense, who cares?
Just don't get hit, it'll be fine.
Yeah, I never get hit, it's fine. If Final Marcus is the big dude on Valet Mountain, yeah, he's the first. Sort of super boss in that he is level 100, and yeah, they're now pikes. I've almost certainly got heart to heart to do.
I think theirs might be on Prison Island.
It might well be, yeah. I'm gonna have a look at that. Bionis Interior, so we're close.
So just a little bit before, yeah.
Yeah, That's good. You can tell, like, I've been using that team for the mission. Oh, Shulk and Fiora are now level 95, so yeah, we're pretty good.
Yep.
But yeah, I've got to go hand in this, Orion, Charla, and Melia gotta go hand in this Lily, which is the Bionis Leg. Just swoop over here. Yeah, Velik is just lousy with super bosses.
Yeah.
Let's see if I accidentally annoy the dragon. The level 120 dragon.
It kind of makes sense that Valak has them, though, because it's so far out of the way. Like, they're not getting in the way of anything. You know, it's like an extra area in the Bionis. It's a good place to put them.
So surprised me when I was looking for unique monsters, I found a level 99 dinosaur that only appears after the Mikado's core. By the Petrified Forest. I'm like, oh, I didn't know, like, a unique dragon, like, spawns over there.
Yeah.
Oh, I should change my party. It's fine.
Look at all that infinity going to waste.
I know.
Feel the inefficiency.
I know. I have been extremely efficient at affinity, which is why everyone's at, like, purple cloud.
And yet, you decided to get complacent
complacent right at the end, yeah.
Well, I just want you to know that it's on video now for everyone to see and to see your weakness. And
absolutely.
We will not forget this moment.
I will never forget. All right. So I think this might be the Fiora. Fiora's fifth skill branch quest. At least I hope so. Alright, yeah, so we killed the big spider. And he's like, oh no, two more have, like, shown up and they're fighting, so everyone's screwed. Alright, so we got to go fix that.
There's a power vacuum in Tephra Cave. Just go fight these really strong spiders.
I love fighting big monsters.
Oh.
Aww. I didn't mean you, I meant Ryan.
Specifically, Ryan.
I mean, all three of you, including that Nopon.
I mean, he is jacked up for an Nopon.
I chose a very good squad for that, that line.
The mech, the bird, and the Nopon.
Hell yeah. Alright, tell us. When you come back, alright. I believe these two, like, unique monsters are level 98. Reckless Zandan, who's at the Arachnid Queen's Nest, and Firework Gedalcia, who's also there. So this should be, this is the skill branch. This is one of the final quests in the game to do.
Gives you a ton of experience.
Yeah. You're my best shot. Aw, Amelia. Alright, so should I try it with this team?
Why not? Like, the worst that happens is that you have to restart the fight with another team.
Yeah. Amelia's level 95 now from that. Alright. Oh, wait, do I have... No, it looks like that one on the Bionis leg is not a heart-to-heart. I can do... Ah, it's Dunban and Charlotte Pink. Well, I normally get that one.
Yeah.
I normally use Shulk, Dunban, and Charlotte as my go-to team. I've replaced Dunban a lot with Fiora on these streams. Let's go to Tephra Cave. The easiest way to get to the, this is the nest.
Yeah, I guess that warp point there, I don't know how close
that's
that is.
That's the Heavenly Windjill. The only problem with that is that's, where all the level 95 monsters live. It honestly might be easier if just,
The leg pass. And then down to kneecap hill.
Yep.
I know it's not actually that far, but it feels annoying when you have to walk any kind of distance in this game.
Well, we get a lovely shot of the destroyed Pocatus. So.
Yep. It's nice that it does update, like, how it goes through the game.
Yeah, I love when you can see it moving. I love that you can see it just utterly destroyed right now. It's so good. Again?
Alley-oop.
Alright. Gotta kill two big lads.
Do we have to fight them both at the same time?
I kind of think so, but at level 95, that shouldn't be a problem. See if I can, like, take them all.
Oh, there they are.
So, yeah. Oh, no, they have spikes, which means I'm going to need Shulk.
Oh.
Ah, terrible.
God damn hero of the Homs.
All right. I want Fiora anyway, and yeah, potentially I might roll with this. Ricky, like, doubling up as healer, we'll see if it works.
I mean, he's very excited about the opportunity.
Absolutely. Alright. I'm not sure I can attack them one at a time. I might. And I get the feeling like it's just like really difficult.
Yeah. They might just everyone just aggro on you immediately.
Urge. If I had melee as like fifth skill branch, like 50% less spikes, like I probably wouldn't need shulk, but I don't have that yet.
Yeah. Oh wait, yeah, he's attacking me now. I think, or is he?
Is he just hanging back? I think the spider's hanging back.
Yeah.
I think I've managed to get it. Looking at level 95, like, on their own, these monsters aren't gonna be, like, scary. See if I can topple it.
I mean, you're pretty well kitted out anyway for high level fights. So.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I did topple it. Ah, I didn't get through, but... Right, I always forget to say sorry, eliminates spike thing.
We see
the
in
danger
this case,
of Ricky!
In this case, the boss doesn't actually know our name. Because it's an ape and a spider.
Yeah. Dragons know names. Spiders,
yeah.
Absolutely not. Purge. No, not you say sorry this time. We'll topple. But yeah, if you can kind of get them at the side, you can kind of trick this fight and not. You are absolutely supposed to do it.
Like so when you said we won't use say sorry this time,
and
then you just immediately used it.
I'm very good at this. I was thinking of something else and I just used it. I killed him anyway though, so yeah. Fighting both of them at once sucks, but yeah, what at a time or not.
The spider just sort of sat back and went, I guess I'm the boss now.
But yeah, he has day spikes.
Oh, day spikes.
Way yikes. Worse. I beat the easier of them first. Oh shit, we're all dazed.
God, yeah, this must be a nightmare if you fight them at the same time.
Yeah, it's awful. You kind of do end up just ignoring the spider and taking down the Gogo first, and then, yeah, like, doing basically what I did but also getting smacked by the spider. You're hearing the noise, sorry, I'm just trying to get this right away before everyone gets fucking dazed.
Yeah, before you auto-attack him again.
Everyone's dazed. The problem is because everyone's dazed, they're not undazing me.
Right.
Which means, like, I'm not, like, able to get Purge back up. Like, I need to get Purge as soon as possible, so if they weren't dazed, they could undaze me immediately, and then I could get Purge, and I would just keep using Purge as soon as I got it, and then the daze spikes would never come back. But because they are dazing and then everyone's just sitting waiting, it's every bit as bad as the level 99 fucking dinosaur with topple spikes. They get this in before they, like, daze themselves. Okay, good, I did. So, can you undaze me, please, guys? Thank you.
And then charge.
Alright, hopefully I can get this in.
Hello. He undazed you though, just in time.
They're both dazed.
That's fine, you can undaze. Oh no, I guess not. Monado Purge dazes you.
Yes, Monado Purge dazes you, which is incredibly annoying. Alright.
You'd think they would stop that from happening.
Nope. Fiora is like really bad for these fights, honestly. Okay, that vision tag should get me full bar. Or I might have to use it on the shield instead, but that is a problem as well, is like I get the full bar, but I have to use it on
tank in the tag.
Yup. Have to like try and like bop around. Okay, we're almost at first
again. Oh,
Ricky's dead. No. We're here, Palm.
Yep.
Survive him. Ah! Oh, the spider's rude! Yeah, Toblin Day Spikes are just like. it actually.
I mean, if you didn't have to charge the talent gauge.
Yeah.
I mean, the only thing I would suggest doing would be like, Shulk stays way out away so he can't auto attack.
Yeah.
And then you use whatever the move is, the name that charges his talent gauge.
Yeah, the one that cuts your HP. Yeah. I don't have it on me at the minute, but yeah.
But it doesn't really recharge fast enough to.
She always dazes herself right before I daze myself. Ricky, can you undaze me, please, buddy?
Buddy.
Ricky!
Get your priorities right
here.
Ricky! Hiropon, I know you're having a good time, but.
Yeah, I really wish I could turn, like, auto attacks off.
Yeah.
I'd be like, no, I don't want to auto attack. Like, please. But yeah, I would just like undaze, like I would let them daze and then I would just like undaze them if I could turn like auto attacks off.
Yeah.
This is exactly how the fight gets better. Precisely how it went.
This is the most miserable fight in the game, though.
Yes.
Terrible.
It's absolutely horrible. At least when I had Charla, she was like far back, but.
Yeah.
Come on. Please don't. Okay, good. Now undaze me. Thank you. Okay. So this is like what you want to happen, and then you just like, yeah, I plug away and I should get purged before
it comes back.
Spikes
and then
come
you just
back.
Keep it going the whole way.
Oh, damn. Nah. Okay, undaze me, Ricky. Ricky, please. I didn't quite get there in time.
Yeah.
Yeah, the daze resist gems will also be helpful, but I completely forgot about the fact that this guy is daze specifically.
Ricky.
No, I didn't mean Warren, but
can you go back rather than doing
something? No, you can't actually. You do have to, like, heal me at least, please. Shield up. And get dazed for days. Ricky just really doesn't want to undaze me. I am still killing it, like, very, very slowly.
He helped out there, at least. And then dazed himself.
Yep. And then Fiora dazed herself.
Well, Ricky should come out of it pretty soon.
Come on, Ricky.
No, don't freeze him. Undaze everyone.
Oh, I'm gonna get dazed again. It's fine.
I mean, it's relatively close to death.
Yes. That is, like, this is where, like, I'm like, spikes doesn't bother me normally, this is where spikes fall.
I mean, mercifully, I feel close to death, too. No.
What are you even doing right now, Sheldon? I got very confused there.
Yeah.
Not wanting to, like, do this. Alright, here. Okay, Ricky, pretty good. Get this attack. What I really need is, like, attack speed up as well.
Yeah, so you can charge your arm faster.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'm kind of, like, just slow enough here. This is a problem. Yeah. I think I'm just gonna, like, fucking purge here. Fuck it. See if I can't. Oh, wait, I purged you!
Oh.
Well, balls to me. I definitely purged there.
You did.
The game decided no, I didn't, I guess.
Nope.
And maybe, like, Ricky used to say sorry and I got rid of it, which is, yeah.
Right,
yeah. Ricky is, like, a real liability. Oops.
I love you, Ricky, but you're fucking this up.
Fucking this up a wee bit, Ricky. Alright. I'm gonna get purged back on now. Yeah, the Monado, like, is activating a bit slowly. It's fine, alright. Let's see if I die. Almost dead! So close! Please don't die me. Oh, there we go.
Oh, thank God for that. It's over.
You guys got to experience the fucking level 99 dinosaur on stream, too.
And don't you feel so blessed?
That you didn't have to see it. Yeah. You should. There's a heart to heart here, but I feel like I don't have to. Yeah,
I know.
Ryan Fiora.
I know we're only 50 minutes into the stream, but that did feel like it lasted 3 hours.
Yeah, that was very long. That was long.
Yeah.
But I was winning the race. That was exactly how the topple dinosaur went.
Yeah.
You do just like you just don't get purge in time. The spikes like purge just doesn't last long enough.
I mean, we complained about spikes before and the issues with them, but this just highlights how that's even worse.
Yeah. Like when it's like damage, it's like bad, but at least you get healing and stuff. When it's topple and dazed, you really can't do anything.
It's
about
just
it.
Yeah, now put down the controller.
Yeah. Alright. Now we got the fifth skill branch. Wait, you need to deliver the flower. Wait, are we gonna have to do that for you?
Guess so.
Hi, Integral. Ooh. How am I gonna, like, get the flower to her, then?
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she might stick out if it's a high end here and call
E9.
That's
true, calling E9, she might actually, like, yeah, stick out.
There's a high end tier here who doesn't talk.
I mean, yeah, obviously. No! Well, yeah, but no.
That's completely immaterial to the fact I want to give her a flower.
Aw. Aw. It's true. Yeah, and Shulk doesn't care about your metal body.
I mean, Shulk probably likes that.
Yeah, exactly. He's totally into that.
Yeah.
Aw. I will never see you in Colony 9.
We'll never see you again.
Alright, Turning Knife, speed 5 frames. And she has the Innocent skill branch. So that's her final skill branch. Let's have a look at it. Gives her ether defense up. Improves chain attack damage when in battle with Shulk.
Nice.
Increases art damage if warned of a vision by Shulk.
I see a theme.
Restores HP when taking damage when in battle with Shulk. Prevents tension from being low in battle with Shulk. And grants all stats up buff when encouraged by Shulk. So yeah, this just kind of makes the team of Shulk and Fiora, like, way better. Like, just kind of, like, have Shulk do better.
But, to stop you from passing those on, that's the diamond-shaped ones, isn't it?
Yes.
She can't pass those.
Yeah, she cannot pass them on, because they're all diamond-shaped, and no one, like, passes on, diamond-shaped stuff.
Nope.
They're all, there.
But, so, yeah, you can't just create people who are just very in love with Shulk.
No.
Fiora does not share.
Just Fiora, yeah. Oh yeah, Dunman's done, Charla's done. Yeah, I've actually gotten a lot more skills than I normally do.
Yeah.
Mostly due to the expert stuff.
Well, that branch seems to not take a lot of SP to max out either.
That is the way of most of the fifth skill branches as well. They're like less than the normal ones.
I mean, it makes sense since you get them so late.
So we're gonna double check, but last time I did, fill in all of this except the love source, which requires me to fight Final Marcus.
Yep.
I am of a level that I can do that now, though, so I'm probably gonna go do that, because I think this is the final quest we have in the game, is to go to the Giant's Ruins at the 3-stage summit, and I'm gonna maybe change the time, although I think Final Marcus only comes out at night.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he does.
We'll have a look. As we, warp away to Velik Mountain. Actually, before I do that, I'm gonna do the two heart-to-hearts here before I forget them. I believe there is. You know, there isn't any in the mountain. There's one in the marsh, one in the forest, one in the tomb, one in the fallen arm, and now two in Prison Island.
Yeah.
No, one in Prison Island, one in the interior. That's
okay. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's right. I have a lot of places to bop and get some heart-to-hearts, so...
Can you not just have them all in Colony 6? Why do you need to be in this disgusting interior of the Bionis to talk about these things?
I was thinking like King Squeeze is like, no, it's just his model.
Yeah, that is King Squeeze, though.
It totally is, yeah. Alright, who is having a heart-to-heart by the fountain? Is it Fiora and Ricky? No, that's not! No! I didn't want to talk to you!
Colony 6 resident.
Ugh, gross.
Get out of here.
It is indeed. Yeah. I was right.
Dream team. Ricky, you really fucked it up for us fighting that spider.
Get a little bit. It's fine. I love you anyway.
I do love him, but god damn, he drives me crazy.
He is hovering over that fountain. It brings back memories.
It's very cute that she's talking to him while he stands on the fountain.
So I know. It's so cute. It's like when, like, they use Ricky, like, physically in these heart-to-hearts quite a bit, like with him in the hot spring.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from in Ricky Forest, yeah. I'm not gonna say, oh, not all memories are good, that's sad.
Not all memories are good, Ricky. I feel nothing but darkness.
Ricky is dad today.
He's very dad with those glasses.
Yeah, those are dad glasses.
Mm.
Yeah, Doomless Forest. Yay! Oh, her head's moving up and down with him!
He's gotta look him in the eyes all the time.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, Ricky's bouncing, you're watching that, right?
Mm-hmm.
I love the way you speak, Ricky. Adorable.
Aww.
Aww. It's because he's adorable. No pun, not magic.
Ricky's a wizard.
Ricky's not a wizard. Wizards have no morals and do not know right from wrong, and Ricky is better than that.
I don't know why you're getting at wizards, but okay.
That's wizards. They have no morals. Everyone knows that. Isn't that right, chat? Wizards don't know right and wrong.
I mean, Ricky's a very moral fellow, so okay. Yeah. I will let that follow.
Mm-hmm. It's true. Yeah, Ricky might not know right from wrong either, but he is better than a wizard. We're getting a shot in at Ryan at the end there.
Yeah.
Alright, so this other one is a pain in the ass to get to. Kind of just have to go here and walk down.
Yeah.
At least there's no dragon.
It's true, the dragon is dead.
Dragon's gone.
Never to return again.
Along with the wisps, I guess he just scared them off forever.
Quite nice, actually.
Yeah.
Maybe he ate all the wisps, and then that's why they're gone.
Okay.
Now we got rid of him.
Mm-hmm. Wander on over. So yeah, it's all the way along in this top entrance, and there are stairs there. But yeah, there's kind of no good warp point to get up here for this.
Why do we have heart-to-heart away from warp points?
Ah, terrible. Alright, which one's this?
I suppose people warping in the middle of your heartfelt conversation would be quite annoying.
It would be very rude, yes.
This is the best outfit from their heart-to-heart.
This is going to be a very good outfit.
They look like they've just woken up.
1 year on... Yeah.
Probably a bit more than that now.
Yeah, well, 1 year, a few months, I guess.
Yeah.
What? You're cursed? Oh no. Oh no, survivor's guilt.
Oh,
no. I was glad you came back. Where was your sister? Yeah, he did not come back from the battle doing very good.
No, the Monado was a bit of a dick.
Yeah, turns out Zanza is an asshole.
Who could have guessed?
I know. Gods, eh? What, jealous of him being, like, wrecked by a sword? Someone's like, what?
I mean, Ryan picked that sword up and it just puppeted him around.
It did a wee bit.
Like, Dunban's so badass, even when it's not meant for him, he could fight with it.
You're young for war, but a year later, you're old enough for war. You are an idiot, and you're still an idiot, but, you know.
You're a bigger idiot now, and that's what matters.
And that's all that matters. It's on.
Ryan, Dunban can definitely take you in a fight.
100%, yes.
It's not even close. He's gonna kick your ass.
That man would kick many people's asses. Alright, to the three-stage summit. We're gonna open that goddamn door. We're gonna kill some slowbos. I'm gonna change my teams.
In that order.
Yeah. So, Ellie's level 97, so this should actually be pretty easy, honestly.
Yeah, it shouldn't be too bad. Mickey's 96.
Yeah? He had an EXP gem on for a while. It kind of gave him some levels. Jura doesn't have one on right now because they're replacing it. Anyway, let's get that yellow slowbo shrub. And probably get murdered by unit monster at some point.
During the day,
so maybe not. It's snowing now, so that's terrifying. We don't actually know what the triggers are for these lads.
God.
This guy is dying horribly though.
He just mulched him.
Wow! Yeah, a little bit, Jesus! That's not what I need. Alright, do you have what I need?
The killing has to keep on going.
Just keep on murdering, that level 120 dragon is gonna come down and kick my ass.
I mean, you beat it up in that training thing.
Yep. How hard can it be? Funny to be mincing a little 97.
Mm.
Oh, that should do it. That should get me the last replica Monado.
Yep. Yellow slope rock.
Alright, so normally I would sneak past here, but no need. I can just kill them now. Ooh, thanks for the experience. That's gonna get me like Fiora at level 96. Ooh, not quite.
Ooh, very close.
Wait, what monster is behind me? The red dot.
Look, can you let us pick up the Titan plate first?
Oh, invite you Slowbo. No, he's fine. He's level 99. I'm like, is that the dragon? It's like, no, it's fine. It's fine, actually.
The dragon's a bit big to get in here.
I was watching that red dot through the booth. What's behind me? What's about to kick my ass?
I don't know who invited this guy.
Not me!
Maybe it's like, you open the door, I'm allowed to come in.
It's true, yeah.
One of those assholes. My turn. Ah, water.
Rubbish! Didn't even get that chain attack. I was hoping to get the chain attack for the sword drones.
Yeah.
This chain on the sword drones is fucking nasty, but Nope, denied. Oh, hello, what's up? Oh, Thrust, oh dear. Doesn't do that much damage though, toppled. So, you know. Not that scary, I'll hold.
There's a lot of lines in this game which I just haven't heard before, just because there's just so much.
Yeah.
And they're quite funny.
Every time you play this game and you try out like new parties and new people when getting quests and stuff, you're gonna hear new stuff and it's really good.
I think a lot of it gets covered up as well by some of the louder comments.
Yes, absolutely. Down
the Yeah, but then you got rid of the top and would say sorry again.
Yep, it's fine. I knew that, but it did more damage, so I was okay with it.
I see.
Yeah, like, he's not doing much damage even with those moves.
No, exactly. Fine.
I forgot you had to fight it. I feel like I didn't. I feel like I did, you know, you run in, you grab the chest, and then you can kind of just, like, bugger off.
Yeah, because you finish the quest just by opening the door.
Yeah.
So if you get the reward, then there's no reason to stay.
I didn't even pay attention to what was in the chest there.
It was Titan Plate, I think, was some of it.
Yeah, a couple of
Titan Greaves too. I can't remember what the other stuff was.
Right, so I guess the thing is now, and I want to fight Final Marcus to see if I can get the thing from him. I don't really want to fight the dragon because I can't beat him. I'm not set up to beat the dragon.
Hmm.
You need very specific setups to murder the super bosses. Apart from Final Marcus, who's kind of like... Final Marcus is the one you use to get the stuff you need to beat up the super bosses.
Yeah.
He drops a lot of the good gems and stuff that you want. So this has changed to night. Gloria. Yeah. I think I have Spite.
Mm-hmm. And there's Marcus.
Final Marcus. Probably gonna need... I'm gonna need my good party.
Yeah, I think so.
Party already has pink affinity, but... They kind of have
not that to... Doesn't really matter at this point, does it?
Nope. Wanna, like, I don't want anyone hit you, and then back off a bit.
I mean, just because he's not like the final super boss, chat, doesn't mean he's not the final Marcus.
Yeah, he is the final Marcus.
Yes, exactly. There's no Marcuses that follow him, but, you know.
I kind of wanted to not grab Final Marcus before I kick this guy's ass, but...
Yeah, we want to wait.
But...
It'd be nice for Fiora to get a heal, for instance.
Nope! Good. Back off. Heal up a wee bit. Then, yeah, go for Final Marcus. We'll see if that other one joins in. The answer is probably... Oh, missed. Unless I just missed, it's fine. But yeah, Fiora just kind of melts against damage despite...
Yeah, the consequence of attacking so many times.
Yep.
Oh,
she's
geez.
Great because she makes mincemeat, but oh, whoops, that's my bad. I did it like right as she dies. Like, oh no, wait,
Yeah.
Oops.
It's a little awkward.
Yep, that's gonna make reviving her weird. Nice. It's fine, right? It's fine.
I mean, I guess we'll see.
Like, auto-attack, please, will you? Like, Shulk's actually not bad at getting, heart gauge.
Yep, and you've got enough to revive her now.
Yep. And with his, like, backslash and, side hits, he can get, like... As long as he's not being targeted, he can get, he can get heart gauge. Right. Get purge.
I mean, it's a lot easier to charge a purge when you're not getting toppled every hit.
Yes, this is so weird.
I do love the enemies just pivoting on the spot.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
no. I got it, though, I got it. Hopefully, okay, good, I'm close enough to actually do the auto attacks. When he found me, it's like, oh god, am I just outraged? He's so big. It was essentially what I wanted to happen, like purging before the spikes came in. His auto attack speed is something I should just put up on Shulk.
Yeah.
I suspect this weapon, this Monado, is a bit slow.
Yeah.
Fuck it, you. Don't want to drag the other one or the dragon into this.
No. Definitely not the dragon.
And I have purge at the start of the. Yeah. It's always a juggle of, like, do I, like, chance it that we're gonna get a stretch, or do I just,
take the extra damage.
Take the extra damage now, yeah.
I guess it's, like, that early on in the chain, does double wins do a comparable amount anyway?
Yeah. Went with the Mai, doesn't it? That doesn't sound good.
I mean, Charlotte's not feeling too well.
But yeah, because you can get, like, Marcus into, like, yellow, you can even get him into, like, you know, brown. Like,
yeah.
Like, he's not like the other super bosses where you really do have to have, like, all the proper shit. You need the night vision, you need to, like, somehow bypass the accuracy, like, debuff you have from things being, like, 6 levels higher.
Yeah, I mean, this one you can get so that 7 level thing is not a problem. Mm-hmm. There's one other boss who's, like, level 105, so you can just get the limit with him.
Okay, so what you want from him in order to get the love source is he drops a glyph. It's, like, a 15% chance. From a little higher level, I'd probably bring Ricky to the fight, because that'll, you know, increase the chances of it. So I think it's Snow. I feel like the dragon should come down, so I might, like, say hello.
Yeah, I can hear flapping.
Don't you just, like, everyone says hello when you're, like, here?
Chat saying that it has to be blizzarding.
Maybe blizzard. It's not quite blizzarding yet. That would make sense. I'm not sure how to get it to blizzard. Change times until like something happens. I think it was like blizzard at night specifically, which is such an awkward. It is a really awkward thing. Like when you got a time and a weather, like I don't know how much you have to change the time to get weather to go. I normally do it by like 8 hours, but yeah, trying to get a time and a weather has been a bit of a bane. Like I had to do it for another unique monster on Valley Mountain, and it's really difficult. And you just have to keep changing the time until it happens. And I'm just gonna get murdered by the dragon, but yeah, you kind of just have to keep spinning that dial. And I don't know if, like, spinning it all the way around, like this, like, does that count it as, like, 1 hour back? Oh, that looks like a blizzard.
Oh. And it is nighttime.
Okay. Is the dragon gonna swoop down on my axe? Oh, there he is!
Nope,
hello!
There he is. Hey buddy, you look
glad.
Familiar.
Glad! Avalanche Abyssay. So yeah, I'm safe over here.
Go.
There he is.
Go.
I'm not gonna fight him, he's gonna kill me. If you're fighting them, monsters don't disappear when weather changes. If you're fighting something else and the weather changes, they will appear. And they will fight you. Mm-hmm. So you can be, he's gonna kill me instantly. Well, if I die, I just, like, warp here, right?
Yeah.
I could just, like, get murdered instantly. And that'd be
yeah,
fun.
Go get melted. Looks like we don't have a choice. There's no way win. Jeez.
Woo!
Well, that didn't go so
womp,
great.
Womp. I think it went really well, actually.
GG, guys. GG.
Yeah, it went real good. Went real good. Alright, so we got the giant's treasure, but, like, yeah, we did the quest, but... the guy, I guess the guy who gave us the quest isn't that bothered about actually hearing from us? Is it Zane who gave us the quest? No, I guess he has a link with Elior.
That's all he cares about is Elior. What about the door you sent us to do?
Yeah, you sent us to go get that treasure, and it was totally not even remotely worth it. Yeah, it just kind of ends that quest line. Alright, so I have to go give the replica Monado. I'm going to go to the interior, because it says Colony 6, but the interior is absolutely the easier place to hand in that quest. Oh, something I really... the third one is actually full of enemies now. Including two unique monsters that I went and beat up off stream. I completely forgot that enemies are now in that bit. So the third long is where we traveled through to get to Magna Forest.
The forest, yeah. So there's not much reason to go back there.
Yeah, there's no reason to go back there. And I was like, oh, there are two unique monsters there? Yeah, it's just full of, it's exactly the same as the other bit of the interior. It's full of monsters now. They were level 70, so they're really, like, no problem at level 70.
Yeah.
So. Alright, let's hand in this replica Monado. Let me see if I can get like heart to heart at the same time. Hello. And then I'll probably beat the game. This seems fun.
Yeah.
Like I can always like load up and like do some other like heart to heart stuff at the end. But I'd like to see the ending of the game today. I have finished. Hell yeah, the saga. But yeah, the only other thing I wanted to do was finish the other category in Collectopedia. But again, I can always, like, when I do Future Connections, I can always just start up that with, like, coming in and, like, doing some more stuff.
Yeah, finishing off the last things.
Like, today I really want to see the end of the game. So, I want this to be, like, the last end of the stream for a little bit. I want a break. But, I mean, I love this game, but I have played it for like 113 hours and a few months.
Yeah, it's been a little while.
Alright, so yeah, there's one there and one there. They're not too far from... I'm actually, yeah, this game does have an end. It isn't just side quests all the way down. I'm actually done. I'm done with side quests. I have no more side quests in the
game. There are no more side quests. Finally.
I know. I have beaten them all. And yeah, I'm looking forward to Future Connected, but I am just going to take a break. I know that Saber wants to do it on his own, so...
Yeah. So I will not be joining for Future Connected.
Yeah, Fiora's body.
Oh yeah. I mean, oh yeah. Oh,
mm-hmm. What's up?
Is it about my body?
Is it about my Mechon body? Yep. That's all everybody wants to talk about. Oops, so Charlotte may have noticed that Fiora's body ain't doing so good.
Goddamn medical professionals.
Yeah, is it obvious? A little obvious.
Damn it. Should have lied to her face. Taken the affinity drop.
Yep. It's all over. Yeah, she's gonna become a doctor.
Oh.
We'll meet a doctor. Hell yeah. Yeah, so Charlotte is not dumb. She has noticed Fiora's not doing too good because she is a medic.
I get you would want the medic to notice.
Yeah.
But we've got other things on our mind at the moment, Charlotte.
No. No. No, I can't.
Droop.
It's fine. Don't make you worry, but I have to go attack and dethrone God. It's fine.
Yeah.
Aww. Stupid or not, that's what I decided. Yeah, she's mentioned a bunch of times in scenes and in Heart to Hearts that she's kind of already thinks herself as having died already.
Yeah.
There we go. Back up to pink. You know, most of them do have like a little heart to heart, a little scene, like Melian and Charla have a little scene. I think Ryan also doesn't, but I don't remember their pink heart to heart, so.
But Ryan is, you know, thick as a two short planks, so it makes sense that he does not notice.
Not the brightest. Alright. No. Oh, there was a unique monster I fought here on the bridge. If you remember, there was like a few dinosaurs that ran down to fight me and I just walked past them.
Yeah, I remember.
So I came down here and they run from all the way up here, so I was chasing them all the way down up here. I fought them. Then they're replaced by like horses, and then they're replaced by a unique monster, like this pig guy, who I don't think I ever fought before. So yeah, there's a unique monster on this bridge that I fought, which was fun.
So is it just Prison Island Heart to Hearts now?
I actually have a few in other places, but I think I want to go and do the end of the game.
Yeah, let's go for
and
it.
And then, you know, when we end the game, I can load up and do some more Heart to Heart stuff. Yeah, just sort of bop around.
Yeah, sounds good.
But like, at 3:15, I feel like, yeah, let's just... I mean, it's really the big thing I have left is now beat the game, now that I've done all the, all the quests. I don't know if that's the Heart to Heart I have on Prison Island. Probably check. Do the one here.
Check while we're here, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I have a little bit to go on Prison Island, but we're very, very close to the point of no return and the final bosses, final scenes of the game. low. I am like 20 levels high. It really is astonishing like how much your level just jumps in the last like 10, 15 hours of this game. Haha, it is.
Ah. Well, this is the one I wanted to see anyway, so.
Yes,
why.
Yeah. He's thinking very hard.
I'm staring into the middle distance.
No! Dog, you paying attention, idiot? Hey, Fiora.
I think maybe at this point he's got hypothermia.
He might do. He's not worn a shirt for a very long time.
We took him through the snowy mountains.
We sure did.
We fought a giant gorilla.
We got him murdered. No, I have cashed in the last Banada side quest. The demonic Everflame and the Slowbush Rock were the last things I needed. So I've gotten all the replica Monados, and I'm going to be like, you're right about me. Hell yeah. Aww.
Aww.
Aww. His Tom Pot hat is very good. Yeah, I have literally no side quests left. I checked. I've done them all. See, Shock has, like, he's, like, still worried about her. And she's like, I'm fine. And he's like, well, okay, if you say you're fine. Okay. Hell yeah. Oh, Shock. Thanks, Shock.
No.
But yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna like lower my level with Definitive Edition. I think I'm just gonna kick the final boss's ass. I thoroughly enjoy kicking Xanatos' ass. By being 20 levels higher than him.
He's the kind of guy you just really want to kick the shit out of.
You really do want to absolutely kick the shit out of him. Yeah. I also understand, like, I have fought him at a reasonable level before. I have fought him, instead of doing all the side quests, I have just gone and fought him before.
Yeah.
And that's also fun, but I'm just gonna kick his ass. I'm level 96 and I'm gonna fucking kill him like I am.
Mm-hmm.
Aha! Combined technology. He's gonna do it. Shulk is a smart lad. He's gonna... gonna do it. Save the girl. Aww.
No.
No! Aww. Oh no! You made the girl cry!
Stop making girls cry, Shulk!
Hell yeah! Picnic in the park! It's a date! Alright, alley-oop!
What? Ow.
Lockdown, alright. Probably. I should really. I mean, I'm probably gonna have to fight Xanatos with Shulk because you're kind of supposed to, but I would love to fight him with, like, the dumbest party possible.
The real hero of this game.
Yeah, I should. Ricky and Thunban and. Who would be the third one?
Ryan, obviously.
You know, that heart to heart is really nice between Shulk and Fiora.
You gotta go with the Himbo Squad.
Yeah, Himbo Squad? Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Shulk is a dork, and it's adorable. Look. So, Imran Eggles are like gargoyles. You don't want to mess with me, because I am 20 levels higher than them. Good lads. Hello.
Very respectful lads. Just
I
sort of
believe there's a unique monster somewhere around this that I didn't fight, because I was like, oh, that's further on than I've been, so I don't want to do that. I don't know exactly where he is, but... Ah, the Belfry. Yeah, Dumbman is too smart to be a himbo, but he's close. What do you call a smart himbo?
He's not very, like, streetwise, though, Dumbman.
Yeah.
Like, he definitely makes terrible choices.
Yes, especially in Friends.
Yeah, exactly. So I think he's got a lot of himbo energy.
He does have some himbo energy, yeah. Ryan is is extremely himbo.
Yeah, no, Ryan is the himbo.
And Ricky's dad.
Yes.
That is something that Ricky and Dunman have big dad energy.
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
Summer Dragon. With a bell, I guess.
And how else would you summon it?
Sure.
We can't complete Colony 6 again.
That is true. Ring a bell.
Yep,
oh, right, there are three dragons in this game.
Mm-hmm.
We do have to fight a dragon in prison. I totally forgot about this dragon. Can we land in the pool? I totally forgot about this dragon. It doesn't help that he's called demon, I think?
Yeah,
he's called dragon.
Yeah, we are going to have to go for extended.
Oh, does CJ's first. Dragon King Alcar. Well, he is only level 79, so I have beaten a level 99 dragon, so he's like, this guy is going to be pathetic.
This is the puniest dragon.
This is the smallest dragon of them all, yes.
Barely worthy of being a dragon.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It's a multi-class dad himbo, yeah? Yeah?
Yeah, it's true.
There he is, the Dragon King Alcar. You have spikes.
Do we just destroy him anyway?
Fuck it, I'm going for it.
Look, we've got nearly 20 levels on him. We can take him.
With damage spikes? Yeah, they are. Just to fuck with Fiora specifically.
Yep.
Where is he? Oh, there he is. He's so big, you wouldn't think I would miss him, but I'm absolutely not speed shifting. I should probably keep it going early on.
Oh, did he just regenerate a bit?
I am gonna murder myself with swords, but...
I mean, you're fairly demolishing him, though.
Yeah, leave it.
Yay.
Hey, Cherry Dragon, if you haven't murdered a dragon yet, this is your first dragon. If you actually fight him when, you know, you're level, like, 78, it's like...
Oh, yeah. He's
strong,
actually tough
but...
if you fight him at an appropriate level.
But if you kind of just end before fighting him like I did and come back at level 96, he's a chump.
Yeah, and then you steal his eye as a trophy.
I absolutely steal a dragon eye as a trophy. Alright, into the altar. And this, I believe, this lift right here is the point of no return. And yes, I believe we're about, like, Dunman's about to warn us that this is the point of no return. If you didn't drag out one of the other dragon eyes, I'm gonna just save here. I'm pretty sure we're gonna get a scene before we go in here, and it's like, hey,
yeah.
Once you go past here, that's it. Yep.
I can sense Dixon. We must be near the top. If we proceed from here,
smell Dixon, Ayo.
We will be unable to return. Are you ready to go on?
Yes, it very specifically is like, you're not going to be able to return. Do you want to go? Do you want to do this? And you can just say no.
No, I need more time. I understand. We'll be ready.
So I really like games that do this, because games that have like really opaque points in no return where you just sort of trip over them and oops, I can't go anywhere now, haha.
Yep.
Really suck. Especially ones that let you save after the point of no return.
Yep.
I can. If we proceed.
So we're gonna go. We're gonna beat the game.
Yes.
And then we're gonna load up and do some more shit. Well, unless this. I don't know how long the ending of the game is.
Aren't it's not that long.
I would be lying if I said no. But still, we must go on.
We're going to get two game endings in a row this week.
We know what
we're finishing Grand Yet tomorrow as well.
We decided ages ago.
Yep, we're in the final dungeon.
Dunban?
Oh, sorry. I just got caught up in the moment.
Come on, Dunban.
Right, let's go.
You should really get changed
time
before we go on Game Call.
No, this is these are the appropriate outfits. The girls are all in their battle armor. And the boys are ready to chill.
Yeah, they just woke up.
Yeah.
rolled out of bed to go fight Dixon.
Absolutely.
As you do. Meanwhile, back at the farm.
Yep.
Atharon, we can't hold out any longer.
Stop complaining.
Stop your bitching.
Believe in Shulk and the others. We will defend this place until they get back. That's the
plan. Up, pothead. Check. Sir, uncheck. I'm ready.
That's true. Chunk is the only one of the boys that turned up in his proper outfit.
Yeah. He's as armored as he gets.
Yeah, hence he has no info energy.
Nope. Hello.
Oh.
Getting a bit of that Zord voice back.
Yeah.
Lad? It's alright, we friend now.
We friend?
We friends? We cool.
We cool.
That faced Mekon.
They're on our side now. They used to be Homs, all of them. They may look different, but they all want the same thing as us. Juju, let's go.
Hell yeah.
I don't know, all Zord really wanted was to eat things.
I don't think that was specifically people. Zord, though. That was a Zord-type mech, but I don't think it was actually Zord. It just had
no,
voice,
no.
Which was good.
But, like,
Zord is, like, super fucking dead. Alright,
I mean,
so, what party should have beat Zanza and Dixon? Oh, Dixon absolutely has to have Dunban. That's just not,
yes.
That's not negotiable. I have to be controlling Dunban. I don't know, I think I get a chance to change party between Dixon and Zanza.
I think so, yeah.
So is it Dunban, Ryan, and Ricky? Is this the squad?
Yeah, this has to be the kill Dixon squad.
Yeah, let's do it. He betrayed being the Hulk Hogan uncle. The dad squad must take him out.
Yep.
Shulk brings two dads, yeah.
Ricky and Dunban are his two dads. Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, the game doesn't let you save past the point of no return as well. Which, again, is good. Don't let people, like, save and screw themselves. Yeah, we've been here before. This is the top of Prison Island, but...
Yeah. This is where we saw Zanza the first time.
Yep, we are inside the biomes.
Yeah, different scenery. We don't get a nice RFC.
Nope. Melee deserves a fair crack at God. Yeah, you're not wrong.
No, that's just a good point. That's the Grandia 2 ending, when you bring both your girlfriends.
Yes!
Kept me waiting a while, Shulk.
Waiting? For us to fight you?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
It's been a while. You went and fucked around for like 15 hours.
You just shut up and let me kill you.
We'll never
you
do
know,
that.
You know, make the game a lot shorter.
Just as I expected. Wouldn't have it any other way.
Yeah, Shulk has his best bro, two dads, two girlfriends, and Shulk.
Since the beginning.
And the medic.
I raised you purely so he could live on.
Maybe the matchmaker.
I know.
Yeah. The
and
shipper,
I must
yeah.
Thank you for granting me such power.
Yeah, Dixon. Fucking idiot.
It's all down to you.
You really screwed
here.
This one up.
For you now.
Enough talk, boy.
Because we very briefly saw this in the flashback with Ego, but Dixon isn't actually a hog.
No.
Dixon.
He's a giant.
If you're so determined to stop us.
And that's why he's been calling us beasts and he doesn't give a fuck about like hogs. He is literally a different species.
Yeah. He's got a lot of Braska's final way on.
He's spikes. What a jerk! I think I knew that he had spikes. Again, if they're like status effect spikes, I normally would just like not realize he had it.
Yeah. The damage spikes there are status.
It's paralysis, it looks like.
Right.
But everyone's paralyzed.
Not the worst spike, status effect.
Totally fine.
I mean, he's already pretty close.
Oh, yeah, he's level 80, we're chunking him.
Oh, story moment.
Yep.
This is getting boring. You were.
That should have been 5 seconds.
Again, when you're level 99, a lot of these scenes get a little incongruous, but that's always going to happen when you become level 99. Huh?
Yeah, exactly.
I've inherited her memories. That's why I fight you.
Fiora!
Memories, huh?
Yeah, his giant form just shows in a couple of flashbacks.
Can't use memories to kill anyone.
Why are you fighting?
Yeah.
You're helping Zanza to create a world where nothing exists.
This is the last time we hear this, actually.
What could you possibly hope to get out of it?
Only those with power have the right to decide such things.
You're wrong.
God, he's such a groupie.
He really is.
Where to fight, and I fight. And that's how I like it.
I don't have to think too hard.
Is that your reason for fighting?
It's the only reason.
Maynooth wished for a world where the peoples of Bionis and Mechonis could live hand in hand. You will never get away with this!
Is that right? Then what are you gonna do about it? In that feeble body? That body doesn't have a Monado anymore. Who knows how much life it's got in it?
Enough to kill you, fucker.
I mean, goodbyes. Definitely.
It can't be.
I'm fine.
Wow. Way to give the game away, Dixon, you asshole.
Right? I've been lying that I'm fine this whole time. How dare you?
Yeah.
Well then, we better make this quick.
Yeah, even at the appropriate level, the final bosses aren't too bad. That's mostly because, again, like once you're at this level, you are really strong. What's with all your gems and stuff that, like, again, I'm taking down things in yellow, like, no problem. Like the dragon.
Yeah.
Be careful!
Well, it's a little late, Fiora.
It's time to learn your place!
You kind of ignored the several other people standing around here.
I mean, you did just stand and do a lot of nothing, though, didn't you?
They were kind of all knocked down, it's fine.
Yeah.
Do not throw your life away for this scoundrel!
She's right. They're all getting back up.
You have to take what you want. There's no point in dying!
Oh fuck, I forgot this was a squad.
Shulk, show him what you're made of. Come on, man. You don't need the Monado to take down this piece of scum.
You sure don't, and I'm not using it.
No, Ricky, no.
Ricky has fish.
No, Shulk, brave. Ricky want to see the old Shulk. Shulk is real Heropon.
Shulk! Real power comes from within!
Yeah, Ricky's gonna bash you with a fish.
In your own true strength, Shulk!
I like that even at this point, we still don't see Ricky actually attack anything.
I know, it's true.
Oh, he's running up.
Here he goes, gonna bash him with a fish.
It's time, Shulk. Let's finish this.
I will not fail. With your faith in me, and our strength combined,
friendship!
Sir, you ever gonna make this worth my while?
Huh? Hell yeah!
Can't be that power!
Yes!
Yeah, it's back.
I love when it segues into this music. It's so good. The music in this game is so good. And they get the cues spot on.
He's got all his health back. What a dick.
What a dick. But, yeah. They really did, like, make the music and the scenes hand in hand. You can really tell
what they did. Yeah. There's good direction. There's good thing. It works really well.
Let's change something. Come up. Hopefully I can get around to Blossom Dance there. That would be very good.
Yeah.
No!
Oh. Just have to sell for 69,000 damage.
Yes, they have the Monado in them all along. We have been told we had to find the true Minato after all.
The true Minato is the friend we met at one point.
It sure is. The real Minato is Ricky's thing.
Yeah.
Cheer up, Ricky. And I'll get cheer up, Ryan. They're all sad because they're getting paralyzed.
Yeah.
It's like the big downside of the stat debuffing ones is that when you get hit by a status effect, your tech goes down.
Yeah.
But. I'm kicking his ass. So.
It's no day spikes.
No, it's no topple spikes or day spikes. Yeah.
Hey, final ball for Dunbar. Love it.
Revenge! Everyone just yelling. How is it
possible without the Manada?
I mean, have you seen his sword?
Stand and fight!
Pretty Manado-y.
Cool. You got some fight in you, then.
He does have a lot of... He's a lot like Metal Face right now.
Yeah. He definitely replaces Metal Face in his career.
Yeah.
He's like, I've had enough! Fuck the shit!
My favorite bit in the whole game.
I know!
Go!
He's like, fuck this shit. My life I'm not gonna die! Fuck that!
You expect us to let you go?
I mean, yeah.
It's Sansa we're such after. A loser.
I love it.
I thought you were okay. Cool, motorcycle Dunkle. You're actually a dick. Hulk Hogan, you are not.
So, you know what? If I'm gonna die, I didn't think I was gonna die, but now I do, so fuck it, I'm leaving.
You're not my friend anymore.
Yeah, he loves fighting and not dying.
How that kid gets so strong.
Like, he likes his god, but not enough to die for him.
I ain't gonna let you see me die.
Some disciple.
It is actually, he is actually
satisfaction of
victory.
He's just like, you're not gonna get to fucking see it.
Yep. Asshole to the end.
Looks
like yep.
The student finally surpassed the teacher.
I don't know how much he actually taught us, though.
Well, he was around. He taught us a bunch about the Manado and stuff.
He was kind of more like a guidebook, really.
Yeah, he was that weird uncle who came in to give, like, sage advice every so often.
Yeah.
Visual metaphor. Bye, Dixon. Yeah, rip Dixon, 10 out of 10 villain. 100%. I love Dixon as a villain.
He's so good.
He's very good.
Yeah. This game, its villains in this game are so good.
Yes, all of them. All of them are great. Metal Face is great. Like, Eggle's great. Dixon's great. Good. And, yeah, and Zanza's a right motherfucker. I'm looking forward to kicking his ass.
Great news, guys. We're back where we want to be. In space.
We're in space.
It's a Xeno game, we're always gonna end up in space.
Yep. Oh, he sees us coming.
Darn, visions of the future.
Why can I not see any further? Now that I possess both Manados, I should
please
be
please turn
them
into
the
wicked big swords.
Why does the vision end here? Huh? So Dixon has passed. Lorethea too. How can this be? Are Telethia growing weak? How could they be defeated by such worthless mortals?
This world belongs to you all. Create a world with no need for gods.
A world that has no need for gods. There is no world without a god. This world belongs to me!
He's very needy.
Yeah, he is a little bit. It is impressive how they, like, he is like Shulk, but the way he says lines and the way he looks is like, you can tell he's not Shulk.
Yeah, it's good subtle acting there, really.
Oops, space. We're in always... space. What don't happened? Worry about it.
At nighttime, is Ricky have bad dream?
Look down. Look at all the stars.
We're not on Bionis anymore. There's no land or sea either.
There's a laser, though.
Chuck, you've been here several times.
So, yeah, we can actually see, near our landmark, Saturn. And there's a thing over there we might have to go fight.
So, we are actually in our solar system.
Yeah, we are. That's Saturn right there.
Yeah.
You could see the rings of Saturn that we were in them when Shulk was floating.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't have to fight Spirit Momkar, but I feel like, fuck him.
I mean, Dunban wants to fight Spirit Momkar.
Oh, absolutely, 100%. Dunban needs revenge here. I mean, if you're low enough a level, you will have to fight him because he'll come get you, but...
I mean, Shulk talked him out of it before, so...
Yeah, Dunban needs to get back. Okay, so this runs so well on Switch. Like, it definitely had quite a bit of, slowdown from the original. Still, like, very impressive. But yeah, if you couldn't tell it was the Rings of Saturn before, that's where Shulk was.
I suppose you could argue it could be any planet with rings, but yes. No, it is Saturn. It is Saturn. It's specifically Saturn.
Yeah, I had to like...
Ah, oh, that looks familiar.
Now we're at Jupiter. Ah, yes. I should change. Who should I fight? I think Melia has to come in for this final fight.
Feels yeah, perfect, I think so.
God. I mean, considering what they did to her people, she needs revenge. So I guess the question is, who else?
I think Shulk, Fiora, Melia is pretty good.
Shulk, Fiora, Melia? Yeah, that seems like a pretty good. They seem like the three that have really been, like, fucked over by Zanza and deserve to, like, do a murder.
Yeah, I think so.
Like, which one do I control? That's very tricky. I want to, like, fight with all of them if I could.
Well, you can always switch between them as you lead up to the fight. We've got a few enemies to go through first.
Oh, yeah. Hey,
buddy.
Zord. Hey, Zord.
I'm always glad to see Zord, even if it is just in spirit.
Even if he's not really
doing anything. He's not even attacking for a while.
I know, because we're just going so fast, we're just kicking his ass for Zord.
No.
Yeah, Shulkar and Ryan also, like, there are lots of good teams to take on Zander, which is another reason why, like, super leveled, I can just bring whoever I want. It's great. I'm afraid you have much to learn about the fairy sex, Shulk. It's a Shulk getting dunked by the ladies.
Yep. Killing God, easy. Not being a dork, impossible.
Mm-hmm. Here?
Oh, hey, buddy.
Mars. Hello, hello. Which Telethia are you? You're just Telethia. Okay.
Just a Telethia.
No, it's just Telethia.
By
the way, the guide says Spirit Rackmum and Spirit Drox. Because once again, the guide is like, that. The name is a spoiler, so I'm going to put it backwards, even though by this point in the game...
Oh, come on. Zord's not a spoiler.
Right?
That name means nothing to you.
Like... Yeah, and even like, oh, you fight Spirit Momkar isn't really a spoiler, because it's just
It could be just Momkar as a human.
Zanza's backwards too, it's Asnas. It even has spoilers in the New Game Plus section, I went and had a look at it. It tries to disguise spoilers there, and I'm like, why? If I'm looking at the New Game Plus section...
Yeah, I know what's going on. Hey.
Stop it. Sorry, it's Tlogad.
Tlogad. Sorry, I got it wrong too. Jade, could have just called him Jade Face.
Like, I appreciate guys that do try not to spoil, because Game of Thrones is littered with guys that love to spoil all the big moments in the game. This guy doesn't. Like, for the most part, it's really good, but the backwards name is just silly.
Yeah. I mean, I think I've said it before, I'm still impressed they hide. Still, as a community, they hide who the 7th playable characters.
Yeah.
That's still, like, a really cool thing the community does.
Like, despite the fact that, like, it's spoiled by basically everywhere else, like Smash.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Is that a ball of water?
So, you finally made it, Shulk.
Yeah, we made it past the moon, so I wonder what that ball of water is.
Riku lives on the moon.
What is it, Shulk?
I cannot wait sure to does. See which path you choose. Let us meet again after you have made your choice.
When Smash is sort of went like, you know what, this game's 10 years old. The spoiler,
Statue limitations,
limitations
spoiler.
Is
yeah.
over. And then they made a remake.
Yeah. Hello.
Hey, buddy.
How you doing, Zanza?
Oh, man, he's sort of glowing now, too.
He's, yeah, welcome, he's gone sure. full JRPG god villain. Got
yeah.
armored up.
That voice. It's Zanza.
Full Bionis.
But he looks different.
I had planned to use the body obtained from Shulk as a vessel in which to dwell for the next millennium.
I fucking hate looking at your face, dude.
However, I came to possess a great and unexpected power.
Maineth's Monado.
Correct. In addition to my own Monado, which you kept safe for me, I was
you can really
also
get a sense
able
of his aesthetics
of
his outfit.
Weapon,
and why
yeah.
he made the Telethia like that.
And why everyone just thinks he's such an asshole.
Yup. He made all the things on Bionis in his image.
Yeah.
He's literally the god.
Well, I suppose that's true of real religion as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
More used to me than any of my disciples.
Now, yeah, sure was.
I can forgive you your betrayal.
Fuck you!
You're gonna give him a reward?
Yeah, what you got for us?
I will have him serve as my new disciple.
Ah, fuck you.
You will be granted
what a reward.
Unimaginable strength.
I'm sure he won't betray
death
us.
Will be but a fleeting afterthought.
Are you so arrogant to believe that the High Entia... No. All life on Bionis are nothing but your plaything.
He is a god.
Playthings?
Yes. You don't know how it
I do not understand the terminology.
What?
After they are transformed into Telethia.
What are you talking about? A Telethia is a High Entia's true form.
I do really love that like, Zanza's motives are that of a god.
The Telethia are mere
like,
cells.
Yeah, he doesn't give a shit.
Body.
It's like giving a shit about like ants in your apartment,
upon them
you know?
On a mistaken yeah. whim. Creating a primitive life form. The High Entia. They enjoy
he literally can't conceive of them as anything
beings.
But...
For that, they should be grateful.
Like, things to serve his bidding.
So this is the arrogance of a creator.
It sure is.
As I planned, the life of Bionis existed simply to serve as my vessels and my food. Bionis is nothing more than an accumulation of their corpses and life energy.
But though you feign omnipotence, the High Entia still confined you to Prison Island. That is how limited you are.
Confined me.
I mean, he's got a point.
I was merely resting there for a while.
Until you were not confined
I was
anymore.
Wounded in the battle with Maynard's vessel.
Well, he knew that he was going to get out.
The day when a
yeah,
new
yeah. I mean, time passes.
Revealed
you know.
To me in a vision would be born.
It's not so much intended, he just didn't give a shit.
I was born.
I think he's, spinning this.
A little bit. But he also just was like, yeah, fuck it, whatever.
Yeah, it's fine, I got time.
I got time, I see the future.
I had no idea that I would defeat her so easily.
Maineth.
He doesn't tell the future that well then, does he?
You did a great deed in granting me a new Monado.
Well, as always, there are people who exist outside of fate. Which is, Shulk and Fira.
Shulk.
And Maineth, obviously.
I don't want to be your vessel or your disciple.
Get your sword out of my face!
My life and my arms in a world without you!
That is most regrettable. You could have entrusted all to me and attained peace. But perhaps the vision of mortals will ever remain limited. Using
music
one's
in the
power to change the world. That is a right possessed only by gods.
Is that why you laid waste to Makonis?
You can't have a rival god.
Along
yeah.
with the beings called Machina, who followed Maynard.
Only me one of us.
They had evolved and become insolent under her protection.
So you're saying us Homs are next in line, eh?
Yeah, you're very insolent, Ryan.
You yourselves have proven that typically you, dangerous Ryan. Species. How unfortunate. I had a desire for friendship. But granting intelligence to the lives I created was a mistake.
He's such a dick. It's exactly what like talking with a god would be like. For
friendship. He's just someone who's just like so you're deluded.
Right.
Maynard chose to exist alongside us.
If you have all that power, you just, it's just what happens. He's lonely, so I made some friends, but you guys want to fucking attack and dethrone me? Fuck that shit.
Our lives as food. Just as I suspected, it appears that I was mistaken to grant free will. However, all will soon
so
be
literally,
over.
Yeah, I wanted you to be slain.
Yeah. Yeah. That's entirely why he made them.
New world. Just as I have done many times before.
Ah, oh, yes, that is true, chat. Xenoblade 2, you do hear bits of this.
Yeah. We will stop you!
Alright.
Yeah, here we go.
Let's fucking do it. And his level is like question mark, but it's like, 80 or something.
Yeah.
He has little babies. Hello.
Oh, hello.
Get dunked. Too early.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's a bit slower than I'm expecting.
So what happens if you lose this fight? I know that's not gonna happen. Like, where do you reappear from?
I don't know. I've never lost this fight.
Yeah.
I genuinely don't know. I don't know if anyone in chat has ever lost this fight. It's not something I've ever done, so... again, because I normally fight him on a level 96.
Yeah.
It's not possible. How can you read my movements?
Yes. Oh, he's like, what the fuck, man?
I will say he's Xenoblade 2, the final boss, puts up a bit more of a fight than this guy. That's one thing Xenoblade 2 has.
Yeah. I feel like, again, like... if you're like the same level again, like there is this curve where by the end of the game, even though the enemies are yellow, you are much stronger than when you were level 10 and enemies were yellow. Yeah. Like enemies do just get much easier as long as they're not red. I know he's red, but it doesn't count. It's not the same kind of red.
No.
You can hit enemies and they have a harder time hitting you than, you know, because all your stats are so much higher.
I'm not sure this is a good look for you, Zanta.
It's fine. It's very Telethia as well. Which again is really consistent and really cool. But you can tell that the Telethia were made by a guy who has no sense of taste.
Yeah, absolutely none.
None whatsoever.
Just completely
tasteless. Yes, I love that Zanza just cannot like conceive of the beings he made being able to hurt him.
Yeah.
Again, the game is really good at sort of getting across that this guy, he is a god and he doesn't think with mortal motivations.
Yeah.
A lot of the games, just like gods are just like really powerful people, so they're still like greedy and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Or just want to blow up the world because fuck it, the world's there and blow it up, why not? Like,
I mean, it's just sitting there, this whole orb. You might as well, you know. The worst that can happen.
It's like he wants to like take it, he wants to get power, he wants to remake it.
Yeah.
And he really doesn't see people as a threat because he made them. Look at you, yep. Garbage bugs. I made you so I could eat.
How can you have visions? You no longer possess the Monado.
I don't know. Not a great glamour or not.
It comes from the bottom of my heart.
What a nonsense.
It shows me my enemy. It reveals the future I must change.
The future we see is not set in stone. There are infinite possibilities based on the paths we choose. You should be well aware of this notion. For that is how you have always existed.
That is a right for gods, and gods only! Why should we care?
Fuck these
What's important isn't whether you can see the future or not. It's the will to make a choice, and the strength to seize your destiny.
This is some real comic book time for dialogue here.
Hell yeah, I love it. Beautiful. Yeah, we're all getting Monadams!
Hey!
Yes, fighting with God is a philosophical exercise in and of itself.
It is
true. Not only you that has the right. Every living thing has the freedom to choose the path they walk.
I love this song.
And that is the future.
A third Monado has appeared. How can this have happened? You are mere mortals!
Yeah, weren't you listening?
Ricky trundling up.
Yeah! Go, Ricky!
One second later, Ricky just like, chumps him in the face.
With a fish, Monado. But yeah, Shulk does have a new sword, and I believe the sword carries over in game boss. Not that I have ever played new game boss. I have never played New Game Plus in this game because you like carry over your levels, which is less of a problem with expert mode, admittedly. And you carry over all your gear, and I kind of just always wanted to just play the game again. I wanted to replay it, like I just wanted to, you know, like replay it. It does have a buff. Nom nom nom! Eat that Zanza!
Yeah, so this is the it's the Monado 3. And
got him.
Yeah, there we go.
Those last a little bit longer if you're not on the mixer.
So when you reach level 72 power, the Monado 3 reaches 999 minimum and maximum attack.
Yeah. Cannot be overcome. No, so with expert mode, the not carrying over levels, that is, like, mitigated somewhat. But yeah, in the original, you carry over levels, like, well, I don't really want to play the game over 96. Determined by providence. That power, although great, is not unlimited. Hey, Riku, what's up? That voice.
Alvis! He knows a lot for not being a god.
Fucking Alvis!
I am Monado. I was here at the beginning. And I will proclaim the end.
But that's impossible.
Oh, there's three dots.
It is time for you to choose.
Of course, does that's a symbol. To I just realized in that triangle.
Or does it belong to you?
That is something.
That was where is
I
that?
I decided long ago.
Yeah, I forgot we kind of formed that three dot pattern.
That symbol.
Uh-oh.
We use our power to fell a god, and then
fuck him up.
Seize our destiny.
Yeah, from the very start of the game, Alvis has had the Monado three-dot triangle on his
the memory of a god's existence,
on his hoodie,
born from the chaos of creation. It is.
It's very easy to miss that.
He's also wearing the necklace, which is the symbol of the Monado in Xenoblade 2.
Yeah, and when Fiora shows up and shows, like, the plate, which is the Monado symbol, you start not seeing Alvis's back anymore.
Yeah. This is my home. I live in space.
Hello.
Let's begin the experiment. Whose voice was that?
It is Zanza, before he became a god, when he was simply a man of flesh and blood.
No! The results have not been confirmed. It's too dangerous.
And that voice?
Hey, Maynath.
It's Maynath. Ridiculous. It's perfectly safe. We are about to bear witness to the birth of a universe. Once, only a god could perform such a miracle. But today, mankind moves one step closer to the divine.
Truly, Xander was Elon Musk all along.
Yep. It's Klaus. But yeah, it's also a response that's like foreshadowing, where it's also like it shows you, but then it stops showing you right about the time you start getting context.
Yeah.
And it's really solid. It's really good storytelling.
The curiosity of a single.
But yeah,
man
oops. Klaus kind of remade the universe. Oops,
so what you're really saying is Klaus was Edge Maverick all along.
Yeah, he was, yeah, oops.
This is a secret Star Ocean 4.
No, how dare you, fuck you! How dare you slander this game so?
So they created life in their own image. And that was how we were born. As the world advanced to each further stage, it was inherited by generations of different life forms.
This reveal is very good. I know a lot of people who don't like this reveal, but I feel they're wrong. Of Zanza this reveal is being foreshadowed a lot. Zanza
it sort of pushes it into kind of more sci-fi kind of place than it is.
He
so
wished
I get that.
For a world in a perpetual cycle of destruction and recreation. Bionis being filled with life. And the
I feel like this game like,
to wipe it out.
Exists in between fantasy and sci-fi.
It was all the
yeah.
will of Zanza.
And this definitely tips it into it the sci-fi, was. But I love that. I love that shit.
But the truth of
yeah,
the matter
I guess it's just kind of how much like going into space is kind of like whether you accept that as being a thing that's valid for this kind of game.
I do. It's so good.
Yeah. I'm more than happy to have wild
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, I just walk in this. It's on the ocean. It's Jesus. Oh
it
no.
It might have been possible.
I did come back from the dead.
Correct. However, that time has passed. The old god was defeated by the new god that he himself created.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, this cycle has.
Yes.
That yeah, is we're the new god now. That's us. We're god. Shook.
Alvis, what are you? I am the administrative computer of a phase transition experiment facility.
To you, yep, that doesn't mean a lot to me either.
That is my original form.
But Alvis is the machine Alvis, that Zanza accidentally used to fuck up the universe.
It has expired. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I will ask you, its new god, what is your wish?
Do you wish to be God? Y slash N.
To stagnate, or will you allow it to evolve to the next level? The choice is yours to make.
I don't know. All I wanted to do was stop Zanza having his way. That's all. I cannot be a god.
Too right.
I mean, look at me, I'm a dwarf. Oh, hello.
No way I can't even put a shirt on.
Everyone.
Look, don't worry, Shulk. None of us want to be gods anyway. And I don't
Ricky's
really
just
know
like,
what
excuse
jobs,
me.
But we just want to live our life as it comes.
We have already attacked and dethroned it's God, and now it's like, do you want to be God? And we're like, no.
Well, we'd have to attack and dethrone ourselves.
That'd be weird, yes.
Yeah, let's not do that.
Yes, he's right. And being with the ones we love, that's enough. Even so, we change little by little. Every day is a little different from the last. We do not know what the future will hold.
More fun not knowing!
Yes!
Ricky want to have fun!
Life's little surprises are what makes it great. We don't know what's going to happen. It's worrying sometimes, but it's also exciting. Don't you think?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Isn't that called progress? Aren't we all continuously evolving? I'm not sure we need a more dramatic change than that.
Yeah.
We're making a world without You're gods!
Right. Little by little. Each day as it comes.
Get rid of that throne.
That's how
Hell
we
yeah.
should live. That's our world.
Yeah, Ricky attacked and dethroned God.
But
yeah.
I recreated their personalities from
all
your
his, little pawns.
Yep. He is the hero pawn,
Alvis.
After all. Those are
like
fakes, it's fine,
don't
worry about it.
Decisions. I'm supposed to be the god.
Apologies. However,
I was being
I
cheeky.
Good reason.
Yep.
This world has little time remaining if left in this state. Have you made your decision? The choice is yours, Creator. Tell me your decision for the future of this world.
I won't decide. The future should be decided by each and every person in the world. And so, what we wish for is a world with no gods.
I do have a soft spot for JRPGs with that end with, like, fuck gods. We don't need them. Let's create a world without them. Great.
The Shin Megami Tensei neutral ending.
Yeah, and like FF13 and this game.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Kill God.
I mean, in FF13, the God's capitalism, so yeah, of course.
It's true, absolutely. Alright, here we go. Remaking Universe. No gods. Only swirls.
Lots of swirls. Oh, look, we made a universe. Someone in a really far away starts going, oh, did someone kill God again?
That happens every couple of millennia.
Jeez, we just got settled on this planet.
All of our calculations. Zanza does feel like pretty Old Testament God.
Yeah. I'd say a lot of Gnosticism in that.
Yeah. Hey, look. Oh, hello. Lots of different races mingling.
Yeah, isn't that nice?
Hi, how are you?
You idiot! Are you trying to kill me?
Gratash still alive.
How the hell is that man still
alive?
Oh,
there's a chief. Yes.
There you go.
Everyone looking at me like, God, that guy won't shut up.
Ah, yes. That's excellent. So, you can take the materials to District 4.
The restoration's coming along nicely.
You done that, Heothar?
Thanks to Melia and Venea. The Hyantia and Machina have some amazing technology.
We are happy to help.
That Colony 6 is probably where I built it before.
After all, I have no doubt. This is what Lady Mayneth and Egil would have wanted.
Hear, hear.
I don't know. Egil did kind of want to kill everything, even to the end.
He changed his mind in the end.
He did that by trying to kill Bionis again.
Well, mostly Zanza, but...
Yeah.
He just left. I don't know where he's gone.
He was just in a lot of pain. I mean, Zanza was a jerk.
Okay.
That's true. He was very early on the Zanza's a jerk train, so let's give him credit for that.
Yep.
It's nothing.
I'm sad you're not in, like, the outfit I had you in.
God,
the setting would be great if, like, everyone was in their outfits. Hi, how you doing?
If you're looking for Shulk, he is not here.
Amazing! It's like you've got eyes in the back of your head.
I do.
What were you looking at? The sea?
I wasn't looking at anything in particular. If anything, Fiora, I was thinking. Thinking about the future that awaits us all.
Wow. I can see the scenery's looking a little
so
different.
You're so much more thoughtful than me.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
With things in the distance.
I don't think so.
There's a big body of water right there.
Yeah.
But I know what you mean.
With a settlement on it we haven't seen before.
We've been through a lot.
Yes. We have. I am grateful to all of you. It is because I met you that I experienced so much, and it is the reason I am here now.
Yes, we're happy you're here too. Thanks, Melia, for everything. I'm glad I met you.
And I, you.
Don't look directly at the sun, Fiora.
Yeah. Great. Ricky!
Yes.
Really good music.
I was about to say, cat me some fish, Ryan.
Some fish! Don't fall, no!
No.
Idiots!
Ricky's going fishing himself. Oh.
Who hates Ricky? They're wrong. Anyone who hates Ricky is wrong.
When was the last time you fished? Oh, I'm bad fisherman.
Terrible, yeah. He's pretty bad at it. You try next time, Furball. But yeah, salt water? Weird.
Hang on a sec. Isn't Okka gonna have a massive go at you if you don't go back to her with 14 fish to feed all your little pond?
Very angry if not catch more fish. Ryan, hurry up, catch him!
Catch me more fish! Catch fish now! Oh, they're so good. Oh, it's Lad.
This game needed more Okka in it, honestly.
Yeah, she's the best.
Yeah.
Here you are. The breeze feels so good.
Oh no, he's got the cat face.
It does.
No, he has a shirt, which is terrible.
This isn't Shulk.
Look at that. Fiora has her body back.
Alright, the first thing we see of her body is her butt, you know.
It's her hair, actually. You see a bit of hair and eyes for her.
No, it starts with her butt, and then you see her body, and then it pans up.
No, you see a glimpse. Fine.
It looks good on you, that's all. Yeah.
Really? Oh, I was thinking about growing it out, but...
You look very cute.
Hey,
yeah.
Which do you prefer?
Don't ask Shulk, he never has a preference.
Come on. What am I supposed to
Shulk
say to
has
that?
No taste.
You know that already.
Okay. It's great like that. Don't change it.
My god, you made a decision.
Yes!
I've what it feels like to do this. I wonder what the future has in store for us.
Who knows?
Yes, Ryan has to catch
I'm sure it will be full of ups and downs.
Ups and downs?
I don't know what the future holds.
Don't see the future anymore.
But that means I can imagine the possibilities.
We're not thinking about the sequel because it's garbage. Put our minds to.
Yeah.
Well,
you're right.
It's kind of more of like same time as this, really. So it's not really a sequel. Remember what the Menendo? We can just pretend it never happened.
I do pretend it never happened. Said to us
the last time yeah.
We saw him. There's no two.
Yes,
it didn't happen.
Of course.
This is the only
X
one.
X definitely did happen for the soundtrack alone.
Yes.
But other than that.
Yeah. Hey, Elvis.
You're looking a bit less green and glowy than last time I saw you. But many forms of life.
I can see it. In this world, all life will be. The X for me is 500 hours played and not recommended.
Oh, I'd recommend X to anyone.
I don't know, I waver on it.
I still need to finish X.
I still haven't finished X, yeah.
Yeah.
Will I ever? No.
Probably not.
No. At this point, no.
Ah, setting up the Wii U is just such a pain.
Yeah, it is, yeah. I know. It's a British one as well.
We'll meet them. And whatever happens, we'll face our future together.
No.
Yeah, things looking a little different, huh? That is like the head of the Bionis.
Yep.
Great credits. I will take Future Connected as a sequel. That replaces Xenoblade 2, which I don't like.
It kind of really is the sequel, honestly.
Yeah. So many British names.
Yeah. Just random British actors.
Yeah. But, like, there are, of course, like, voice acting studios in Britain. Like, Ni No Kuni has British voice acting in it, like proper British voice acting in it, both one and two, although much more twee than this game.
Yeah, well, that's the difference with this game and what kind of gives it a lot of its unique feel is that this is not a game that was chosen as British actors because they wanted to get a feel across with it. This was British voice actors because they were localizing it. They had no budget. It was only going to be released, like, as it's
English,
it was Britain. That was it.
Yep.
So it was done on the cheap with no-name actors.
Well, some of them are in, like, the Dark Souls games, so they're not, like, no-name, but, like, they're not, like, the, you know, the American voice actors that are in everything.
Yeah, exactly. You're not
Matt
having,
Mercer,
like,
and stuff, yeah.
Yuri Lavanov is not every character, is what I'm saying. I mean, the obvious exception to that is Jenna Coleman, who, of course, wasn't a name at the time.
Yeah, a lot of them are in, like FF14 is another one. A lot of them are in Dragon Age. So, yeah, they're, like, kind of, like, mid-tier, like, actors. They're not, like, you know, Grandia, who are no-name actors from the 90s.
That's when voice acting wasn't really a thing.
Yeah. But yeah, Xenoblade X had a lot of American voice actors in it, and Xenoblade 2 always bothers me because it feels like they lent in to the British accents and kind of went overboard.
Yeah,
and then it didn't feel real anymore.
Xenoblade 2 is actually, like, what happens when you go, we want this to be British voice acted, rather than we're just hiring people and they are British.
They are British, yeah.
Like, everyone we're hiring is British because that's where we're doing the voice acting.
Yeah.
Whereas 2 tries it deliberately, and that's why 2
like
isn't that good.
Yeah, I don't... I really don't like the voice acting in 2 at all. Like, I feel like it's not right. The Nopon also are wrong.
Yeah, they're wrong.
Like, they're just wrong. It's, I don't know when it's just, like, the cadence, but they don't actually have the Nopon dialect, like, down properly, which is weird, because it's fine in X.
No, they sort of just... I mean, Tatsu's annoying as hell in X, but he does speak like an Opon.
He speaks like an Opon, yeah.
Whereas in 2, they just talk like the other characters.
Yeah, but occasionally, like, drop a word.
Yeah.
In the wrong place. Yeah, Rebecca and I are playing Resonance of Fate offline. I bought the remaster on sale.
Right.
With an X got on it. It's really funny. He's just Lloyd. I'm like, oh, that's just Lloyd. I forgot he was Lloyd.
Yeah. Should we talk a little bit about this game that we actually just finished rather than complaining about 2?
Do we ever? Right, okay. I mean, we talked a lot about it in the endings, but I really like the ending of this game. I really do. I like the sci-fi shift. Like, when I play it again, I see a lot more of the sci-fi stuff that is littered through the game. Like, the first time I played it, the sci-fi twist was definitely, like, hit me, like, oh, wow, it's actually sci-fi? I just thought it was, like, fantasy with, like, a couple of robots in it. But, like, they talk about, like, the genetics of, like, the Hyent and the Telethia.
Yeah.
There is lots of technology. There's lots of hints about, like, the fact that you go to space in those visions with Shulk. Alvis's whole thing about his computer and the symbol of the Monado is a computer symbol.
Yeah.
And Alvis is an AI. and I do feel like most everything in this game is, like, foreshadowed incredibly, and it is through, like, playing through it again that you really see all the scenes again with those eyes, and it's like, oh wow, there's this happens, and Alvis talks to Shulk before you even meet him, and stuff like that. It's just like, it's just really well written. This game is really well written.
I think that's kind of what was really impressive about this game at the time, is that especially for coming from RPGs, which generally try to do a lot with a little. They try to do little things that kind of have much bigger messages. And obviously, we're both fans of Final Fantasy XIV, but that game was very bombastic, very stylish, very out there in kind of how it does things.
Yeah.
Whereas this take, with not a lot, and remember, this was a Wii game, you know, with the Wii just did not have a lot of grunt. And it manages to pull out a story. Nice. It manages to pull out a story just from having very effective cutscene direction, very effective
yes.
character work.
Yep.
In a way that you don't see in a lot of JRPGs.
Oh, God,
because
no.
Because a lot of them just, you know, all they have is the aesthetics of a JRPG to go on, where this actually has a lot more going on underneath it. It's just
it really
well-crafted game.
One of the first games with cinematography. Like, especially
yes.
JRPGs. Like, a lot more have come out. Like, I feel like Zestiria and Berseria, Tales of Zestiria and Berseria, are also try that. There's a lot of really good scenes in both those games that are really cinematic.
Mm-hmm.
And that was one of the things that struck me so hard. The Fiora's death scene, I love this one while sitting there. It's great.
Yeah, great.
Like, Fiora's death scene was the big one where it's like, it's not just good because it's such a dramatic, inciting moment and it really grips you in the narrative, though that's all great. It's just
yeah.
incredibly well shot. It's incredibly well delivered. There's so many scenes that have so much action in them and are just framed really well.
And that's the thing with that scene as well, because that's such a trope that the girlfriend gets killed at the start.
Yeah.
Like, immediately, I mean, how many games have you played where that's happened and you go, oh, great, fridged, and you're already taken against the game? Like, just from the use of that, or a trope that's very similar, you know, one where you're just like, well, that's a very tropey thing to have
happen.
Not
very many JRPGs actually fridge the love interest. They just have the love interest, the childhood friend who follows them everywhere and is obviously in love with them, but we're never going to say it.
Yeah.
That's the way more common, but yeah, I mean, there's definitely stories where, yeah, the lady gets, like, killed off, and I'm like, oh, okay, fuck it.
Yeah, exactly. But that's the thing, is that it's so effectively done that you're just on board with it. It doesn't actually bother you in any way.
I was
you're
so
like,
on
yep,
board.
Let's go kill him. Let's go kill
that fucker. That grabbed my heart and did not let go. I loved Fiora. I love Fiora. She's my favorite character in the game. And the way she killed her, she was so brave. And she saved Shulk and the others from Mumkar. And then the way he just, like, stabs, it was so visceral.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was a character I played with for, you know, about 8 hours because I do all the side stuff. So, you know, I played with her, I liked her. Like, she was great. And then it was just, she was just destroyed. And I was with Shulk. I was on this quest for revenge right from the start. But the music, the cinematography, all of that, really gave it that sort of, like, feel to it. Like, it wouldn't be the same if it was, like, any other JRPG that killed it off. Like, I feel like Star Ocean 4.
Yeah.
Which only came out, like, a year or two before, has, like, lots of people who die. You kill an entire planet.
You do destroy an entire universe in that game.
Yeah, you do destroy, like, alternate Earth, but you don't... While I always feel like people give Edge too much shit for being upset for destroying a whole planet, you don't actually feel sad that he destroyed a whole planet. Like, you don't...
Because
there
he's
are no
just
stakes
idiot.
To it. Yeah, he's an idiot. There are no stakes to it. You don't know any of the people who died. I had one in the corner.
It might be the one by... I think that's Melian Dunban's final one, isn't it? The one by Mumkar.
Yeah, I think it's this one, actually. I fought the dude that was here. He's not here in Thunderstorm, but I did fight him.
I mean, honestly, that's a really good example of how bad execution just ruins what you're going for. Because you can see, logically, why he'd be really upset about that.
Yes.
But it doesn't land because, you see, we don't know anyone on that planet. It's an alternate Earth, so it doesn't matter because it's not the real Earth.
Yeah.
And, like, what he does is so stupid that you have no sympathy for him because that was dumb as hell. So, yeah, it's just... like, worlds apart in what they're trying to achieve and how execution just means so much.
Yeah. I mean, it really was, like... To me, this game is, like, not so much perfect, but perfect for me. Like, I everything about it I love. I realize that I really appreciate weird things in video games. Like, I really do. I love music direction. I love, like, battle systems that are interesting. I do feel like this game is interesting. And the narrative is so good, and the characters are so good, and the foreshadowing is so perfect. Like, playing through it again and seeing all the scenes where Zanza is like, only a god can defeat you. I'm just like, you fucking asshole. I did not realize that line for, like, 2 playthroughs. It was, like, the 3rd playthrough I had heard that line, and I'm like, oh, fuck you. You goddamn shit.
As Vickers is pointing out in the chat, that Alvis says at some points that resistance is futile, and I'm afraid I can't let you do that.
Yeah.
which is also great.
It's great.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, there's so much of it where that in the way that it does its twists, because a lot of these games, you see something happening and you go, right, okay, well, he's evil or they're evil or that's going to happen. And this game has that. It has the kind of more obvious things that are going on, but it's never like coming out of nowhere or too obvious, just because the craft and how it foreshadows things is so effective. Like when you see Mumkar kill Fiora at the start,
yeah.
You know, the foreshadowing there is with his claws. Yes. And of course, because we see Mumkar at the start with the claw hands and the way that he manipulates them and the focus on those. Yep. And that's your initial foreshadowing of what's going on. But then, of course, you have that the faces can't be attacked by the Monado because
the Monado can't hurt people, which it did show you in the scene. You see the scene where it bounces off Fiora.
Yeah.
And the thing is that you can put some of these pieces together and not others. Like, it took me a while to figure out it was Mumkar, even though I figured out the faces were people, like, really, really early.
Yeah, exactly.
But I do love that, yeah, you talk about, like, it's not just, like, writing that has the foreshadowing, but, yeah, there's scenes that have it, where, yeah, like, it shows the claws, and it does it with visuals, like it's showing Alvis's back, and then subtly hiding Alvis's back from you for a lot of the game.
That's one of the things that works well, because people are so used to having things conveyed to them through dialogue and not through visuals.
Especially like
they're
in video games.
They're used to being told things and then be like, oh, this is what's going to happen, rather than actually watching for themselves.
I feel like video games have come a long way in that sort of storytelling.
Mm-hmm.
And it was definitely not something you see, at least saw in many JRPGs before this one, and you still don't see it in a lot of JRPGs after.
No, I agree. I think Xenoblade, actually, this game came out at a really interesting time, mm-hmm. because this was after the kind of move towards more cinematic gaming. So this was after things like Uncharted and sort of contemporaneous of Uncharted 2. And that was kind of that big push for a more cinematic style.
Yeah.
And this is after things like Tomb Raider and God of War and things like that, which became very quick time event based and watching
stuff.
Yeah,
it's also very different from those times, because that was cinematic in an action movie.
Right. But in that way of conveying things through cutscenes and through motion and through taking cinematic techniques. But crucially, it's before Dark Souls and things like that, which then pushed back on a more gameplay thing and a more conveying things through more reading and through lore and through text dumps and things like that.
Yeah.
So it's in a really interesting time period where it's that kind of focus on cinematography and movement in cutscenes, but before moving to that more gameplay focused, read a whole bunch of item description stuff that Dark Souls made popular.
Yeah, I feel like this game has a great, it has a great melding of gameplay and narrative. Like,
yeah,
I love when you go into, you fight the Hyentia, and you're normally using Shulk, but in a first playthrough, you're almost certainly using Shulk. I was, for sure.
Yeah, I was
too. And you bounce off the Hyentia, and that reminds you through the gameplay that your Monado doesn't work on people right before. This is like a couple of hours before the reveal.
Yeah.
That like the faces are humans. And I hadn't actually, I was like, oh, that's why you bounce off them, because they're people, right?
That fight drove me crazy for like 5 minutes until I realized, oh right, yeah, people.
Yeah, they're people. You're like, why am I bouncing off? And it's like, oh right, the Monado can't hurt people, which includes the Hyentia. And it's a really interesting way to do that with the gameplay, because any other game would have just gone, hey, do you remember? Do you remember the Monado can't hurt people? Do you remember? Do you remember this flashback to a scene? Do you remember? Do you remember that?
It would start the fight. Shulk would have drawn the Monado, and somebody, probably Ryan, because that would have been the stupidest, would have like, don't be stupid, Shulk. You know the Monado can't hurt them. And Shulk wouldn't be able to flexible for the fight.
Yeah.
That's how it would have gone.
Yeah, like, it does flash away a couple of times to, like, Ryan bouncing off the Fiora with the Monado, but not as often as any other game, like, say, Tales of Symphonia fucking 2 would do.
Man or a mouse.
I hate Symphonia 2. But yeah, the Hyentia scene is Ryan bouncing off happened like 20 to 30 hours prior. It flashbacked it probably just once before then.
Yeah.
Like, it flashes back right before the reveal. But by then, you've already figured it out. Like,
the
reveal is right there. And that's why it flashes back to be like, hey, we're revealing this to you now. You remember this? Here it is.
Mm-hmm.
And that's totally fine. It just didn't... I also love that, like, future stuff is in fights.
Yes.
Like, the vision stuff, I don't know if it's implemented, like, the best. That the tags are always a bit awkward, but I love that that's in the game in the first place.
Yeah, and it reinforces the gameplay and the story side of things in a kind of nice synergetic way. I think the combat system works well in the game too.
Yes.
Well, one of the things this game, and it kind of feeds into that theme of it being about people and about your own path and choosing things like that, is that it focuses so much on the world. So you don't go into like a different, you know, phase area to do battles. It's all about in the world. You approach enemies who are all up here on the thing, you fight them. You spend so much time talking to different people and building connections between people and learning about them.
Oh,
because
God,
it's their lives that are important.
The Affinity chart was something that was like, I don't know if I've ever seen in a video game before this one, and it really was another one of those things that's like, oh, I can talk, the NPCs have names, they have connections, they have quests. Like, it was just such an interesting thing I had never, like, seen before, and I was like, wow, that's really cool.
I mean, certainly not in this extent of scale.
Oh,
I mean, normally it'd be a much smaller cast in a much smaller area, and it would be about, you know, I'm thinking like Link's Awakening style, like trade quest kind of things, and doing stuff like that, rather than actually like this is a whole world of people who are doing this stuff.
Absolutely. But yeah, people talking in chat about why like the Monado works on like monsters and not on people, and it's literally just because Zanza made it that way and he was God. Like the High Entity, the Homs, and even the Nopon, he gave them free will and intelligence and like made them out of ether himself, and the monsters are kind of just like bacteria that spawned in him. And it's
even
just
that,
like, and
even
it's
that
like,
big dragon,
pretty big. I want a crystal, I want to take out a village.
Wait, we have to stop discussing to listen to Rick.
Yeah, listen. What are you going to do with that crystal? What are you
going to
do with it?
Going
to
go eat it.
Hell yeah! Sell that crystal. Make money.
I can start being the Hurobon.
Yeah. I don't want to be Hurobon anymore. It's called Ricky's Crazy Crystal Plan, which is an excellent private action name.
Yeah.
You know, all the time, like, oh, God just made it that way. It's like a cop-out kind of story beat, but in this game it's actually like kind of earned. You gotta refine it. You gotta refine it, Ricky.
You gotta make through this money making scheme, Ricky.
Killing God absolutely dissolves all your debts, 100%.
Yeah. I mean, who else could you be more indebted
to? Either furriness.
Oh,
only regular football furriness.
No furnace.
No furnace for Ricky.
Look, we've got an ultra small reactor. We can use that.
Yeah, we've got a portable one. It'll be fine.
Yeah, easy.
We're great.
Yeah, Chazzy and I would hope Ricky wished for a world where he didn't have debt.
Absolutely, he did.
And infinite fish.
Infinite fish. Absolutely infinite fish. But yeah, I mean, you know, I played this game after, like, Vesperia and Star Ocean 4 and that kind of era, and, like, I really like Vesperia a lot.
Yeah, Vesperia sounds.
But Vesperia is so stiff in its cutscenes.
Yes.
Like, going back in the definitive version, you can really see, like, especially between it and Berseria, which, again, is a lot more cinematic. And it really is, like, this was really the first game, like, first JRPG I'd ever seen that tried to do that, and it was just wild to me, and I like the gameplay, and I play JRPGs for the story. I do. People might be like, but their stories are terrible, and I'm like, fuck off, I don't care.
I mean, a lot of them are terrible.
A lot of them are terrible, but I play games because I like to connect with characters and I like to connect with stories, and for a long time, that was JRPGs. You didn't really get, like, not so much good narratives, but sort of just beyond go save this person narratives in a lot of video games. So JRPG was a big niche for me because that's where the narratives lived. And to have a game that was just this well plotted with seven amazing characters, not much horniness to it. I mean, really. Like, even that bit at the end was like Fiora's body, it was really just showing off her body. It was like, that's the most TNA this game has ever been.
Yeah, no, Charles is as bad as it gets. And even that's like, oh god, compare it to two. Two is ridiculous.
Yes, two.
Two isn't even horny, it's just juvenile.
Yes, yes, absolutely. I compare it to like Tales games. Like, I really love Berseria, I hate Velvet's outfit. Yeah, there we go, Dumbman and Melia.
More hearts to hearts.
And like, again, it was like a breath of fresh air to have a game that wasn't constantly, and yes, you can take off the boys' shirts too, which I always appreciate. Hi, Shulk. I've always been more, if it's like more equal opportunity, I'm more okay with it. I also like put up with a lot of it. Like, horny outfits don't bother me too much. Again, I play so many anime games that like, especially the stuff in this game doesn't even like hit on the radar.
Oh yeah, no, this game is completely mild. And that's honestly what makes, we're complaining about 2 again, but it's one of the things that makes 2 so disappointing.
Yes.
Is that it takes a lot of the subtler things that are good about this game and just throws them down the toilet.
I really like a lot of the framing and a lot of these heart-to-hearts where it's like, yeah, hey, we're going to look at something, so they actually frame it so you can see the thing they're looking at.
Yeah, no, normally, again, I'm thinking of, I mean, Tails obviously did it a lot for space issues, but it was just their face cards
the
talking.
Skits. Yeah.
And it just seems, and I get it, you know, there was only so much they could do, but it was just disappointing.
Yeah. Like, I really like, Berseria again has a lot of, it's like the visual novel stuff. You do a lot of portrait work, there's a lot of skits, but they have like full body skits and a lot of portrait work. But like Grandia has like a shit ton of portrait work, which is wild. When we went back to it, it's like, oh my god, this game has so many portraits and sprite work. It's like, Berseria does a lot of stuff in that visual novel stuff, but actually like works with it to actually make it more interesting and dynamic. Mm-hmm. And tell the story well.
Yeah, I mean, and you can like, do a lot of a little, but some games don't even do that.
Yeah, they don't even. But yeah, I really like that. I like the one with Ricky on the top of the distant fingertip where we're looking down. That was so good.
Yeah, exactly. Normally they would just be like standing side by side. I'm thinking like Mass Effect style where it just goes shot, reverse shot, and that's all it would be.
Yeah, a lot of like JRPGs are very just two people stand in a room and talk at each other.
Yeah.
And then there's still a bunch of scenes where they like stand around in this game because you can't have like everything. But they still even try with these to have like different angles and show you stuff and not be so static.
Yeah.
It's a very well done game in basically every respect. I know a lot of people like feel like the battle system isn't great, and I'm like, I like the battle system. I'm one of those people that like it.
I think if you were looking at the pillars of the game and you were sort of saying, like, you know, the story and the conversations is one part, and then the exploration is another part, the side quest stuff, and then the battle system is kind of your third pillar, I would say the battle system is definitely the weakest part of that. And yes, chat, if you're wanting to hate on FF13, please
get
don't
out.
Wait. You're not welcome.
Get out. We love FF13.
So, but the battle system is definitely the weakest of those pillars, but that doesn't necessarily mean that it's bad.
No, I think the battle system is pretty good.
I think one of the things that this game is actually really good at is conveying its battle system in a way that allows people who are not very familiar with an MMO-style DPS tank healer system to actually intuit that system very well.
Yes. I feel like definitely playing this game, I played this game before I played like FF14, and I feel like playing this game definitely is like a way to ease yourself in to that sort of thing. I do feel like even though it could do with a bit more explanation of some stuff sometimes, like a lot of it's just like shoved in tutorials. Like, I do feel like it's pretty easy to just, like, pick up and still be able to play it without, like, too much difficulty.
Yeah, I think, it's interesting because, again, everything comes around to 2. What that does is kind of what you're talking about, which is that it spends a lot more time gradually introducing the battle system to you. Like, even as, like, up to about halfway through the game, it's, like, stopping you and going, hey, we've got this little bit extra to add on to it, to do a bit more.
Goddamn asshole. I'm not entirely sure how to get unique monsters on. Well, there's the invited lads going back in his hole. I see that. Hello.
He's still invited. He can still go in.
See, I disagree with chat about FF13 benefiting from freedom.
I completely disagree.
Yes, FF13's strength is that its lack of freedom is part of the narrative.
Yep.
And again, I love FF13 because it combines narrative and gameplay. Like,
yep, and in fact, FF13 combines it so much, which is probably why people don't like it.
Yes, yeah, it's a big reason, yeah. Like, completely and utterly, 100%. But yeah, I think the original UI of this game needs some work. I don't mind this one, it's pretty functional, it's not too bad.
Yeah.
But
no, the changes that they made to this game are generally very good.
Yes, I agree. I really like the Definitive Edition. I didn't expect to use or like expert mode, but I really do. And all the quality of life stuff has been truly excellent. We're getting end of the 30% respawn chance, yeah. Sounds about right.
What's interesting though is that all this quality of life stuff, it doesn't detract from the original game. It doesn't even it improves it, and this is the version of the game that you should play. For nothing more than just it doesn't take an hour to load the menus.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Everything that was quality about this game was in the original Wii release.
Yeah.
This doesn't fix anything, it just adjusts it and makes it just a smoother experience.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
And God, I wish they got rid of spikes.
Yeah. I feel like they felt that was like messing too much with the game.
No, I agree. They shouldn't have messed with the game that far. But God, I hate spikes.
I hate talking spikes so much.
Yeah.
I've got rid of say sorry still because I don't get rid of the spikes.
Stop getting rid of Purge, Ricky.
We'll just take that off, shall we?
Yeah. Oh, HeroPon.
See if I can get that love source. It's kind of like the final thing for me to get in this game.
Is
the love source.
I know, like, attacking and dethroning God is apparently the point of this game, but really it's the side quest stuff.
Yeah, 100%.
And this is the last thing, really.
Yeah.
Apart from the few heart-to-hearts.
Yes, there's just, like, some of the pink heart-to-hearts. Which, again, we'll see if I ever, like go through and just, like, mash them with videos. Probably just, like, I give a bunch of collectibles out, and that'll probably be enough to do it. I can't imagine they're that far.
No, they must be pretty close.
Yeah. That might be something I do to, like, go into Future Connected, is just, like, show off the last heart parts and then jump into Future Connected.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But,
I
love this game so much.
I mean, I hope by showing it off to people here, we've sort of conveyed kind of what works about it so well.
Yes, yeah.
And I know there's a lot of things that's kind of like, there's a lot of side quests, and there's a lot of content to go through, and people kind of get bogged down in that kind of things. And I think they don't necessarily give it a lot of credit for the things that work really well.
Yeah.
And the things that actually, like, keep people coming back to.
I think absolutely.
We tend, to, like, as a community, to be quite negative about stuff, and even during this, we've been nitpicking, pointing out stuff.
Yeah, we've nitpicked. We've talked about two, which we don't like.
I hope we've conveyed as well that we do really love this game.
Yes,
and it's really great.
I think it's come across how much I
certainly hope
this game. Business Lantern, it's hard to talk about it without, I didn't want to, like, spoil it too much. A lot of the scenes I really love, I can't talk about too much, and a lot of them are, like, foreshadowing. And a lot of that stuff. Like, I love the scene at the start where, like, Shulk is like, there's a voice that part of me wants to just take the life Fiora gave me and just, you know, live it like she would want me to. And there's another voice that's telling me to kill them all.
Mm-hmm.
And that is such a good scene. And it's like, but what makes it really good is that it is foreshadowing Zanza. It's another aspect to that scene.
And yet, it's so subtle that even if, like, on a second playthrough, you might miss it.
Yeah, you might not realize it. There's a lot of stuff like that.
Yeah.
And
that's kind of the thing, is that the localization, the money went to the right places.
Yes,
like,
they
did a really good job in putting it together. And obviously, they had a good thing to work with.
Yep.
But they did a really good job with it.
The voice acting, I don't think we talked about this very much, but the voice acting in this game is really tough.
Yeah, I really like the voice acting in this game.
It's really good. Again, like, I have a big soft spot for it because it is genuinely British rather than, like, twee British.
Yeah.
I play a lot of JRPGs with twee British accents. I like Ni No Kuni, they're real British accents, but they are extreme.
Yeah, they're brought in for an affectation rather than
And then there's like the fake British accents. But the voice acting in general is actually just really good, and they really do like use the Britishness to full effect. Like the fact that Melia has a Silver Spoon posh accent, and yep. Fiora, Ryan, Schalk, and Gunman have varying levels of working class.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, what's interesting is actually comparing it to something like it's the last story, isn't it? The other Wii.
Yes, I like the last story a lot. Yeah.
Which the last story. Definitely picked into the whole regional part of things.
Yes.
Because you had like, Scottish accent, yeah. You had quite strong like, Yorkshire accent.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Rather than this game, which mostly goes for just general English.
Yes.
I mean, there's definitely the north-south divide kind of with Schalk, Ryan, and Fiora, as you say, and Melia.
Yeah.
But say, I mean, the chat's saying there, it's pointing out kind of the ideas of form on polite speech in Japanese voice tracks. And it's using it in that way rather than just, we're going up north, gotta get those Scottish accents in.
Aye, gotta get the Scots in.
Gotta get the Scots, we've got dwarves, they need to be Scottish. Why are dwarves always Scottish?
I mean, they just are. I don't know. They just are. But I mean, the thing that like tweaked it for me is that like a lot of Americans don't understand the inherent class aspects of British accents.
Yes.
Like, they just see all British accents as classy. Whereas we'd be like, really?
I hope that hearing Ryan's accent dissuades them on that.
You would think. But yeah, your average American probably wouldn't notice like the difference between Fiora and Melia, even though it's like blindingly obvious to us.
Yeah. Like, I mean, the thing is, I mean, just get across kind of how stratified British accents are. There are people who can tell which postcode in London you're from because of your accent.
Yeah.
Like, to that level, they would tell, like, which area of London you're from, which street you're on sometimes, just because that's how stratified British society is. That's true, it is probably Lord of the Rings' fault.
Yes, it's always it.
God damn it, Tolkien.
Didn't get it in time.
No.
It's fine, I just revived him.
Yeah, it's fine. Ricky's got back up again.
There you are. Encourage Charlotte. Purge. But yeah, they use the British voice acting really, really well. And the voice actors are all very good. They do a very good job. You can definitely do this. I mean, there is a reason why this is one. I mean, I really like the last story, but it isn't one I play over and over again.
No. This is definitely a superior game.
Yes, this is definitely the best of the three. At some point,
there's a reason. There's a reason that Shulk's in Smash.
Okay, let's see if I hit that, like, 15%. Nope. Am I gonna get this? I don't know. I don't actually know if Ricky even affects it. He affects like the gold chest drops. So I don't know if he affects like what you get out of them.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, there he is again. A bit luckier that time.
Yeah, at least luckier in the spawn.
I don't know if anyone in chat knows whether or not like what actually matters for the 15% drop. I don't think that's the actual item rate. So I might as well just have the faster party in.
I mean, at least it appears even in a woods one, so that's something.
Yep. Yeah, just the faster party. But yeah, I mean, I really like streaming games. I like. I mean, we enjoy having the sub goals for stream like games we don't like. It's fun to like do that. You know, different. If we played like bad games all the time, we'd get like quite wearing.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you gotta have variety.
Yeah, I like playing like weird games that like one of our other us haven't like played before. Games we enjoy, like showing them off. Okay, perfect. I think it's good for this chest, right? If you just like stay me alone below the monsters if you're here, it's a bit awkward. Hey, Marcus, what's up?
Oh, there he goes.
There he go. It's blizzarding now, so like, it comes out of my ass.
There he is.
I just like go back a couple hours. So.
Yeah, let's not get a blizzard coming in.
I would rather not, thanks.
Let's not fight the dragon.
I don't want him killing me again. Alright.
Alright, take three.
Like, the thing is, he is the lowest drop rate for his thing for the left first. Like, ideally you would want to take on the level 105 one. I'm not really geared for that. Let's see how many tries I take trying to get this one.
Yeah, why didn't the dragon kill God?
Yeah, exactly.
Why were we left to do that? Can God create a monster so strong even God cannot kill it?
Yeah, exactly. But yes, I will say my relationship with Star Wars and 4 is pretty unique. It was a great time streaming, but again, it's good as like a part-time thing. And Star Wars and 4 is just like my white whale.
I mean, Star Wars and 4 is just an incredible beast unto itself.
I'm one battle trophy away from the platinum now.
How much time has that taken?
15,000 enemies. It'll be 40 more hours to get it. But yes, taking about 600 hours total.
Wow.
My normal mode file has 400 hours on it now. I know.
Star Ocean 4, man.
I had a lot of fun getting the battle trophy. I enjoy numbers go up.
Well, I mean, the thing with Star Ocean 4, and as chat's pointing it out there, it is the right kind of bad, where it's not just, this is a miserable experience. It's got that, it's like Sonic 06, where it's just playable enough that you're like, this is terrible, but you can still keep going.
Yeah.
Most really bad games, you just stop, because you're like, this is awful.
Yeah, this is miserable, yeah. I have way too big a soft spot for Star Ocean 4, even though I can tell you this is straight up garbage, don't play it.
Yeah.
Whereas
I mean,
this
Star
game
Ocean
is incredible. Play this game, please do. This game is great.
Oh yeah, play Xenoblade.
Xenoblade is a fantastic game. I do think like anyone who is a JRPG fan should play it. I don't know about the non-JRPG fans. I feel like the gameplay might throw you off. But if you're a fan of like really good narrative, the game's great characters, great narrative. It bounced right off of Xenoblade X, too. Xenoblade X is
a Yeah, I think it's certainly an easier sell than X is. Yeah. And it's certainly the things that will turn you off if you're like me, who's someone who's not overly into anime, because certain tropes just are like massive red flags and your hackles get up when you see them.
Yeah.
This game doesn't have any of those. If you don't need a high tolerance for anime to be able to deal with this. You kind of have just to deal with the kind of things that JRPGs do, where you end up attacking and deforming gods.
Yep.
I think this is a pretty open game to get into if you have any sort of interest in JRPGs.
Yeah. I feel like the gameplay is pretty good.
Yeah, I agree.
It's pretty simple. I feel like X went too complicated. And yeah. I don't like 2's very static gameplay at all.
The thing with this game is that it's got enough for however much you want to delve into it. If you want to go do these million side quests, great. If you don't, then that's fine too. Nope.
Never getting this. I'm going to try one more time, and then we'll probably end the stream there, but...
Yeah. How many, items can you get from one chest at a time?
I believe it's 4, but I think only the first one is going to matter here, because it is a material I'm looking
right.
for. So I think it's if I get the yellow Slowpoke Rock, I'm not getting the item I need. Ah, Shulk is now level 97. I could try safe scumming the chest. I'm not sure how well it would work, but definitely something I could attempt. I'm trying to get the item from Final Marcus that's the item from all the super bosses that you can trade for the love sword. I'm pretty sure Final Marcus does drop it. It's just at the lowest possible.
Yeah. He does drop the blood.
Yeah. I know, because I've never killed any of the super bosses in my
game. Yeah, exactly. Rest of it. Same here, so.
But. God, I love this game. I streamed it for 100 hours. I know I've streamed other games for 100 hours, like FFTA2, but I like FFTA2 a lot. I stream games I like. We do generally just stream games we really like. Save before opening. You might respawn on top of it, which would be hilarious. What if I can drag him over to the left a wee bit? We shall see.
Yep.
I assume if I turned it to daytime he wouldn't spawn right on top of it, but...
I mean, I guess the other thing you could do is you could put it on casual mode just so you can kill him super fast.
Oh yeah, true. Yeah, that actually might be good. Yeah, but don't get it like this time. See, what, I've not actually used casual mode, so it'll be really funny. So
yeah, I mean,
I've actually done it.
We got to show off everything in the game, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so it's very long here, so we ended up talking about a lot of random stuff, but that's just terrible when you stream them.
Yeah,
you can't talk about a game for literally as long as it plays. You would, like, duck. I actually don't know if you could take the dragon in casual mode. Do you still have the instant death spikes? That would be pretty funny.
Yeah.
Worth fun.
I think chances are he still has an instant death.
I'm keeping you.
Alright, only 10 o'clock here. I'm only working tomorrow, it's fine. So I can have a long commute to my job.
Still working from home?
Yeah, we're all working from home until God knows when.
That's the state of things.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I actually quibbled a bit over whether I was going to stream this game. For start, it's over 100 hours long. And, like, especially as I love this game, there is a lot of downtime in it.
Yeah.
So I'm glad I've had some help joining me.
Oh, well, it's been good to be here.
It's been good. I've
not you, Saber, I meant Brad Mage.
Yeah, I meant Brad Mage, obviously. No, I've really enjoyed, which is why, like, I'm inviting you back for the next game, which I should maybe announce while I'm trouncing Final Marcus. So, as I said, I'm going to take a break from Xenoblade for a little bit before I do Future Connected. Again, just because I've played this for, like, 114 hours now, I would like to just have a little bit of a break. And I'm going to stream the game I was originally going to stream after I finished Pokemon Black 2. I was going to stream Digimon Cyber Sleuth. And then Xenoblade came out. And the plan shifted. It did indeed. On Mondays, I'm going to stream Digimon, and Saber is invited back. Because you love Digimon too.
We do. So I'm afraid, chat, you can't get rid of me yet.
No. No, we're back.
We're back for that one.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I do like Cyber Sleuth a lot. Cyber Sleuth is, I mean, obviously we'll get into it again, but a surprise is kind of how I would describe Cyber Sleuth.
Yes, genuinely, very good.
A genuinely very pleasant surprise.
Mm-hmm. It is. I like it a lot. I like the Cyber Sleuth sequel a lot more than I liked Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't know if I'll do the sequel. We'll see. But yeah, I want to show off Cyber Sleuth. I've talked about it on stream before. We streamed Dawn? Digimon World Dawn?
Yes.
And that was fun. Like, Cyber Sleuth is like a much better version of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's a very fun game, so I'm looking forward to talking about it on stream. Like I said, I'd already planned to do it. And then Xenoblade was announced. It's like, well, am I going to just stream Xenoblade?
So, back to before we were so rudely interrupted by the game.
All right, fuck it. Casual mode. See, there we're in the daytime now, but he stayed around. Enemies don't blip out if you're fighting them.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so where is casual? Yeah, here we go. When enabled, combat will be easier. It will only affect this save file. Okay, apply these settings. I have no idea what casual mode even does, so I guess we're about to find out.
We're about to find out.
We'll go back to nighttime. Alright, we have to rejigger the landmark. So yeah, it's the same as every other enemy, like, respawns in landmark, so... Alright, we'll kill this one. It's just kind of in the way. Get out. Ah, spike's damage is, like, nothing. 25 there.
Jeez, he is getting mulched.
Yeah, a wee bit. Okay, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
That was pretty fast.
Let's keep going. Let's see what happens to Mr. Final Marcus.
Yeah. I would say, chat's pointing out there, the good thing about Ultra Sun Ultra is Team Rainbow Rocket. They are great.
I was so disappointed with them.
It's so short, but the bits that they're there is great.
Yeah. They're not in it enough. They're not in it enough for my liking, I think is the thing.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Oh, jeez, look at him
Oh, good God, he is dying horribly. Holy shit.
God, he is definitely the final Marcus.
Yeah, because I'm mincing him.
Oh, I love casual mode already.
Wow, yeah. It's like reduced his health massively. I wonder what casual mode has actually done.
I think one of the things it does is it, like, gets rid of, like, the level differences.
Yeah.
So... Yeah, it makes enemy agility arbitrary, apparently.
Yeah.
Oh, you're still trying to...
It'll be interesting to see if I, like, have a chance against the dragon. Oh, we toppled him. Oh, we can go down.
Oh, no.
Womp.
Oh, this is just unfair.
This is mean as hell, and I love it. Can it be anything but me? Bye, Marcus.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, that guy joined in for the fight.
We're fighting something else.
That was a mistake, Mr. Slobos. Charlie was being used because I needed your healing.
Do we, though?
Not in casual mode, you're right. I should totally change it for someone else. I didn't actually know when I came in. I was like, wow, casual mode really does, like, make a huge difference. Huh? So, yeah, I could absolutely, like... change this, so, no, I could make change from this, but,
Yellow Rock again.
Yellow Rock! Alright, well, let's see if I can beat, so Final Marcus is probably back. No, it's fine. So I have to, like, change the time for the dragon, right?
Yeah.
It has to be, like, nighttime, and blizzarding.
Oh. Yeah, that's blizzarding now, yeah.
I think that's the blizzard. Gonna come flying in.
Something that guy's attacking
him. Hi.
Something else that is trying to fight with me.
No one else yet.
Not yet.
Right. Well, I'll keep Charlotte just in case. Oh, there he is.
Oh, there he is.
Lad!
Lads.
Alright, what's up? Am I gonna die? Does he still have the instant death spikes? Let's find out.
Let's find out.
Ooh, hello! Be up a dragon!
Attack and dethrone the true god.
Yes, the dragon. Oh, no, I got instant death there.
Mm-hmm. It's the death spike. It's not over.
Yep, so he still has it. I tried to get rid of it there, but it didn't work. I had to, like, try and get the purge on.
Yeah.
I had to, like, try and hit him rather than reviving here.
Oh, there you go. No, have you got him back already?
Does purge not work on him?
I guess not, because you're not getting rid of the spikes.
No, I'm not, yeah. I had to get 100%, yeah, debuff resist.
Yeah. Okay, even casual
mode. I had a resist come up here. So yeah, even casual mode doesn't prevent death by dragon. There you go.
Yeah.
Even in casual mode, not really that beatable. Alright, well, how's the bunny? Does the bunny have insta-death spikes? The one in the marsh?
I don't know, let me check.
Level 108, I could probably take him in casual mode, right?
Yeah, I would say so. Hang on, let me see. Super boss.
Give it a shot. It's a bunny, how hard could it be?
He's Despotic Arsene, right?
Yep, mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, fine. Let's see if I can kill this bug, because this will have a higher drop rate than Marcus.
Yeah, 31%.
Hello. Marcus only has like 10 or 15, which
yeah.
I could have gotten if I'd gotten lucky, but I had not, so.
Let's kill this guy too.
They kill this bunny.
Yeah.
Look at him baby. Can't be that. Well, all his little bunnies. Yeah, it seems like a character monster can actually hit him.
Yeah, it's gonna make a big difference.
Yeah, that is the thing about the super bosses, is like all red enemies, the big hard point is just being able to hit them. Because they're red, which makes them impossible to hit without, like, the proper setup.
Yeah.
Because I can hit him. Fuck him up.
We can... Yeah, we can daze him. Oh,
immune to daze. Okay. Well?
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah, I mean, you're doing pretty well. I got changed at the end, I guess I killed enough bunnies. Yeah, casual mode is definitely, definitely good for just murdering super bosses for the one thing I want to do left in the stream. God damn it, game, come on. Give me a solid here. Ooh, what you did. Emperor combo.
Oof.
Well, that's what a shield's for, and then I'll just pull off in a few seconds. Yeah. I do have shield at max level, so it does actually last for a pretty long time now, but...
It's kind of, like, good practice, though, isn't it?
Yes, it's good practice not to do it, like, right away.
Yeah.
I've never beaten this bunny before. This feels a little cheaty, but... I can't be bothered actually doing the stuff I need to do.
No, come on.
It's such a faff, honestly.
Yeah. Like, let's just grind Final Marcus for another half an hour.
Yeah, exactly. It really is just like, you need like the night vision stuff so you can actually hit. So you have to fight them all at night.
Yeah.
Look left.
Hey, level up.
No! Game, you're killing me! Alright, I'm trying to think of any other. It's not worth it. Like, beating the Collectopedia is not worth it.
I guess there's... The only other boss who'll have a higher drop rate in this is the other one on Valak Mountain.
What one's that the one?
The level 114 one. So for him, the drop rate's 43%.
Okay, where is he?
Let me see. Found near the Great Glacier. He's the only behemoth found outside Prison Island.
Oh, I forgot this dude there.
Anytime he's found. I don't know if there's any weather. It doesn't say anyway, I don't think.
You never really come here? Yeah, this is the type of monster I fought on the bridge. Look at this lad. Look at this lad. Alright, we'll give him a shot. And then I'm just gonna give up. That'll be the end of the stream. Well, we'll give him a go.
Yeah, and if it doesn't, well, sorry, no
like, this is probably easier for me to, like, save scum, because there are no level 90 enemies that will respawn.
Yeah.
If I get lucky, he won't respawn. He is a big lad. We fought him in the time attack.
Yeah, I remember.
He's trying to get us killed? Yes. Yes, I am. How did you know?
No spikes as well, that's nice.
Yeah, no spikes. Get behind him. Behind this lad. He's a big boy, I've never fought, because I never come to the glacier.
Yeah, exactly. Apparently he is the only source of AP up and talent boost crystals.
That makes sense.
Which are very useful at this point in the game.
Yeah. Oh, he has topple spikes.
Ah.
Fuck that! Fuck that! Get out! Get out of that shit! Okay. It's not allowed.
Not allowed.
Not allowed!
I guess we just do not topple him from now on.
No.
time for a chain attack. All right, I'm here. We go.
Well, yeah, this guy could absolutely attack an ether gun if he wanted.
Yeah, I mean, all these super bosses could.
Yeah. I do like that they only appear after you, like, make sound moves. Again, it's another good storytelling thing, you know, the Bionis, all the Telethia are out, and now all the super bosses are up and about.
Mm-hmm.
God has awoken, and everything's going to shit.
Yep.
Now he has a lot of health, even in casual mode.
Yeah, let me see how much is coming out, man.
Slam!
Yeah, so he's got 600,000 health, so about the same as the dragon we fought earlier.
Yeah.
Here
we go. Okay. My turn. I get to fight them when they're in casual mode. I've never done that before. Okay. Again, I never could be bothered to do it. I mean, I like the battle system, but it's not like a battle system I'm playing solely for the battle system.
Yeah, no, I mean, what I like about this battle system is that it's simple enough and interesting enough that you put a little thought into it and you can actually start, you know, mulching enemies.
Yeah.
But the point where you have to take it so far to fight these guys on normal, like, nah.
Yeah.
But, like, not fun anymore.
The thing about X that really bothered me was because, like, for the most part you were fine with not being able to understand its system, but at some point some of the stuff really expected you to, like, know the systems inside and out. Like, some of the side quests were just like, fuck you if you don't know how to use, like, your gem stuff to the max, even though it's so fucking complicated.
Yeah.
And that's the point where I gave up on the game.
Yeah.
Wait, again, for the battle system, I love FF13's battle system a lot.
Yeah. 13 is the greatest.
That is a game I platinum and I enjoy platinuming, even though a lot of it is involving killing giant turtles over and over again. Because I enjoy killing giant fucking turtles over and over again in that battle system and doing it as fast as possible.
Yeah, those turtles are interesting.
Those turtles are fun. Like, being able to go from, like, the cheese methods from, like, summoning and stuff to just being able to fucking slap them down.
Yeah.
Is a great feeling. It's very satisfying.
Mm-hmm. God bless Sass.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Nice. Oh, we're getting there.
We're getting there. It's very slow because he has a lot of health. Armor isn't really doing much. I'm not really.
Yeah, we're not in.
I could probably have switched out Charlotte.
Yeah.
I just wasn't sure being level 114, but.
I mean, with casual mode on, he's just not doing enough damage to you, really.
Yeah, no.
God, 20,000 damage with that headshot.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, we're getting there.
Oh, man. Did you see how much that took up your chain gauge?
Yeah.
Like, a half full just from that.
It's pretty good. Oh, fuck it, I guess he has an aura and I ain't having that shit.
Yeah, none of that nonsense. Get out of
get
here.
Get out. Get the fuck out. He crazed now. Maybe he'll do some damage. My guess is no. He's trying his best. It's fine. Get him. Get him.
God, how many chain attacks have we used now?
Oh, many? Many. Oh, and I think I've been doing more damage with chain attacks because
there
Pura
we
has
go.
That skill. That was great, guys. I got an affinity
bunny
vibe.
Was way quicker.
Alright, so I think I'm just, like, save here. Ooh, it has a casual mode.
Filthy casual tag.
Save and open. Yep. Ah, you're finished work, of course. It's is that it? Is that the
good
thing?
Yay! We got it!
Who has the love source? Is it that's Colony 6, right? I had it down at some point.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, Jarell in Colony 6. All right, here we go. We're going to finish the Collectpedia. We're going to see what our reward is for finishing the Collectpedia. It's going to be worth it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure. It's totally going to be worth it.
Better fucking be worth it. This is the real end game, folks.
Hell yeah.
This is the culmination of all these hours of streaming.
Is Love Source. There's an achievement for giving Love Source to someone, so you have to actually get two.
You have to get two of them if you want that achievement.
You have to get two of them. I'm pretty happy with how many achievements I got without even, like, trying. 124, 49.
49 of those.
Pretty good. A lot of them are, like, kind of really grindy, but you don't have to ever do.
Yeah, exactly. They're kind of like little bonus things.
This Love Source is going to be the most beautiful, perfect thing in the world, right?
Yeah. The source of all love.
Yeah. Here it is, the Love Source. The Veritas Glyph, the one thing in the game.
That trades for high enough value.
You also have to have both Ricky and Shulk's skills that boost the price of trade stuff. Like, Ricky's does it by 5% and Shulk's does it by 20%. You need both of those, plus this glyph, in order to get this Love Source. It's beautiful.
Look, she knows what she wants. She has a lot of this Love Source, but only takes glyphs.
Here we are, Love Source. A strange love potion much sought after throughout Bionis. We got critical up five.
Sure.
And completion. Aggro down 5! Woo!
Yes!
So worth it.
And an achievement. We're about to pop an achievement. Yes!
Destroyed!
Alright. Beautiful. And that feels like a perfect note to end the Xenoblade streams for now. I'm not entirely sure when I'm going to come back with Future Connected. We'll see, but mwah. We have less aggro and we have Stamp of Insanity and we beat the game. We got the ending, which I really enjoy, and yeah, I hope you guys really enjoyed watching me stream through all of this game. And not quite 100% it, but about as close as you can get. I've done like the vast majority of quests. I've done most of the heart to hearts. I've got all the collectopedia. I have done a lot of this game, and I really, really, really love this game. So I hope you guys will join me next Monday when we're going to play Digimon Cyber Sleuth, another game I really love. And yeah, I hope we have a good time. I'll let you guys know when I decide to play Future Connected on stream, but after how many hours am I on the save file now? 115, just about, yeah.
That's just streamed, really, isn't it?
Well, I did a little bit, probably about 10 of that is off stream,
yeah.
But that's it. The vast majority of that was on stream. And I would definitely love a little break before I jump into completely new content for me. And that'll be a hoot. So tomorrow, we're back with the final stream of Grandia, because beating one JRPG in a week is not enough. We have to beat two. So, join us tomorrow for Grandia, and I'll see you guys then. Bye, everyone.
Night, everyone.